And we are live. Hello, everybody. I am here with Garrett and Kevin from Thought Cops. Garrett, I don't think you need any introduction.
I like an introduction, though. I'd like to hear. I'm just curious. Like, how would you introduce?
How would I introduce you?
Given the chance.
Hypothetically.
Yeah. This is Garrett from Mega 64. They've done it all. They've pretty much... very influential to my sense of humor in high school. In all honesty.
Wow. High praises. Well, thank you. Is it Serb? Can I call you Serb?
Yes, you can. You can call me that.
Well, it's been very nice to be introduced by you, and I've got a lot to live up to. That means a lot. Thanks for having me on. I'm excited to be here. I don't know how this happened. Kevin, Serb, you should introduce Kevin now.
Kevin is me and Kevin have been friends for about a year. Kev runs a podcast called Thought Cops. Good production quality on that. It's very fun. They have a lot of great guests that come on there. It's a new guest every week, so it's very fun to discover new people through it, and it's
a lot of crossover with you guys too.
Yes, exactly. A lot of guests.
That's what I'm finding out.
Yeah,
I'm finding out the crossover within our communities is humongous, and I had no idea.
First thing I have to do is I have to make sure the music level's muted. Last time I played this, I set the soundtrack to only play Separation of Church and Skate. Because I was in like a very ironic NOFX phase at that point in time.
I like to drive the viewers mad as well. Yeah,
I think because the guest that we had, Felix Biederman of Chapo Trap House, was also in an NOFX kick. All right, we're gonna start a new story here.
NOFX is the band with the member. Is his name Fat Tony or Fat Mike?
Davis Simpson? Damn. All right, we're going to do normal. I didn't know there was a too easy mode.
They kind of make it insulting.
Wow.
I tried doing sick and I couldn't get past Miami last time I did it.
What was it Wolfenstein that had the easy mode and then it shows your character
as a
like
baby?
A pacifier.
That's insulting.
And everyone journalist got mad at that shit.
I was just gonna say, Kotaku was not having that one.
They were like,
I was very triggered too.
This is
hardly so.
Hey, DMCA. Hold on. I'll fix this. Trial audio.
Yeah, this isn't dope beats playing in the background. It's just like MIDI.
Yeah, that was a MIDI. I made that myself.
So we're gonna wasn't Muska Beats.
Let me turn up Garrett a little bit more. All right, so now it's all quiet on the set. We're gonna create our character. All right, what kind of guy do you want to be?
So this is I never played this one. I played the first three Tony Hawks a lot when I was a kid.
We can have a skull.
I kind of fell off. Well, that's cool as hell. I didn't know you could do that.
Ooh.
Now.
Tan skin.
Very evil. Is this this is the first Underground? I believe this is like the last one I played.
Two was the one that was like the Bam Margera show. It was really just like Viva La Bam.
Right.
Let's see what we got. We got flat top.
But this one,
sir, we got a question.
Go for it.
Is Darth Maul in this one?
No, that was in three.
Damn it.
Good question.
Four was Jango Jump Jet. They had the Jango Fett in that one. And they had Eddie in four. They had Eddie from what is it?
Iron Maiden?
Yeah.
Iron Maiden?
Yes, sir.
You gotta love the guest appearances. You know, I think that started with like two when they had Spider-Man.
Sorry, I had to adjust stuff.
Oh, yeah, no worries.
We're dealing with freezing screens. It's
Spider-Man. I remember a few days ago, I finally watched the video where like you guys you really wanted to do a Tony Hawk skit.
Oh yeah,
and then you hurt yourself.
Tony Hawk. Yeah, Tony Hawk is like
Marge Simpson hair. Yes.
To me.
We can be
I'm glad
large.
you You're like Kid from Kid and Play with that flat top. I'm glad that that you're having me on while you're playing Tony Hawk, because yeah, I loved these games. I still played when they re-released 1 and 2. I fucking flew through them.
Oh, those, yeah, those were fun as hell.
I'm going to be the White Mars.
But I'm loving skating again. I've been skating a little, and that was kind of the resurgence of it when we made over at Mega 64 that prank video that it was supposed to be a fucking Tony Hawk Pro Skater sketch. But then it just got turned around into a practical joke on me.
They basically got a cameo from Tony Hawk to be like, "Hey Garrett, I hated your video."
Yeah, I meant to ask you about that. Like, so you were completely in the dark about that, right?
Oh, up until the upload, or maybe up until like final edit, and they screened it and tried to capture me on hidden camera in the screening room. But yeah, I was totally in the dark. I thought I had pitched an awesome idea for a fucking classic public game experiment like we love to do over here at Mega 64.
Doing it for years.
Yeah, and then these guys pull the wool over my eyes. They purposefully made the fucking edit terrible and then stuck me in the editing room to get a reaction. And I'm going like, what? Why is this? This makes no sense. Like, why? Why did you cut there? Why does this go on so long? Like, I'm asking all the right questions.
The neurodivergent, I made the White Marge, a neurodivergent minor.
That's good.
And she always pushes Mongo.
Always. That's the most realistic.
All right, so...
Wait, what is Mongo?
I think it's like when you push for your front foot.
You leave your back foot on the board, and you push with the front foot as you take it off to step on the concrete. But not a lot of people... I just don't think it's the preferred method.
I see.
Those fucking wood pushers.
Yeah, it's like having a little... Oh, this game actually has a face mapping feature, but I don't have an eye toy.
Oh, I remember. I remember doing this with my eye toy.
How did it turn out?
Got my ride all set up. It probably looks as bad as that character's face looks. I mean, the faces were not good. Even his face is terrible.
Yeah, even Eric. Well, Eric's face is always terrible because he's Eric.
Fuck Eric.
Who did you pick as? Which is it? Eric Costin?
No. I'm just me. I'm Dwight Marge.
Oh, you're Dwight Marge. Okay.
Eric, did you have an Eric Sparrow growing up?
No.
No, I didn't.
Who's Eric Sparrow?
Your worst friend in this game.
Evil boy.
Oh, gotcha.
The betrayer. The old pool down by the high school, Scabland, the drainage ditch. Oh, I know all these places in Jersey. Elm Street,
our own little strip of paradise. Scabland.
Scabland in Jersey. I've been there. Everyone knows Scabland. Oh, the one thing I wanted to talk about again with the Tony Hawk video is that it was really funny to see you in the editing room, and the thing that you took the most umbrage was that he was using sparklers, and you're like, that's not in the game.
Yeah.
You weren't heated about it. You were just like muttering to yourself, like you're just like a disappointed dad, just like, that's not in the game.
Because I'm thinking like, okay, hey, you're filming stuff that doesn't occur canonically in the game franchise. How this footage is wasted now. I was so disappointed in that. They were veering off of the script. I would understand, you know, you get in a fucking shopping cart or something, but...
Sparklers? It's like, come on!
They just knew... They knew how to piss me off, which was worse as...
So you guys were together for so long. I feel like that's, you know, like, it's the same for like Thought Cops too. Like sometimes I know like the right things to say to like get under Grant's skin just a little bit, just to get a reaction, you know. And I, you know, people love that kind of stuff, you know.
Wait, all right. Like, I feel like the best thing they did to piss you off was to have Sean be the skater to replace you. And they
no,
did.
I was fine with that.
What? But the way they executed it. Go for it. Let's hear the behind the scenes.
Originally, we were both going to wear the costume and skate around. Because if Sean was unsure, because Sean doesn't skate all that much, so he was really like... Oh, dude, I don't know if we can pull off these shots we need to get. And I'm like, look, I'll go in, I'll do the big stuff. And that's, you know, how I ended up hurting my ankle. But you do the, you know, the basic stuff. You be the face, I'll be the stuntman. We got this. So I was fine with him being my counterpart, but I just didn't expect it to be totally Shanghai'd and lampooned.
Yeah, what was really incredible was when they redid the skate letters, where like they just put it up on the roof and had him try to get it down off the skateboard, and then they just put all the skate letters together and had him touch all of them.
So dumb, because they knew, like, he went through this effort of making all these props. He taught us all how to like hook him up to the fishing line and string him across. I mean, I spent a day prepping them for the shoot with my bad ankle. I just wasn't gonna go on the shoot, and it was all a waste of time.
It worked.
Oh, I want to say paid off.
Yeah,
Garrett, the dedication to your craft. I mean, like, having seen it firsthand, like, the last time I was at your guys' studio, you still had the Tokyo 3 set built from like the Evangelion video that was yet to come out.
Yeah.
And it was so cool just to kind of like see that and the whole plug suit and everything. And then you're like, oh yeah, we use this to make this, we use that to make that. And I feel like in the Tony Hawk video, there was parts where I was like, I almost kind of wanted to see the full execution of that.
I wanted to see like an honest go of it.
See?
Yeah.
I do.
Exactly.
But like,
I think like the way it worked out was good, because I think like a little injury, filming schedule. Also, it was like right in the middle of the first wave.
I don't have the stats to pull this off.
You're trying for Christ airs. You need to do a Judas pose.
There we go. Let's see. There we go. I gotta get the stats up.
But one day, Kevin, I think you're right. I really do want to see like what we can accomplish.
It was COVID too. You could interact with people properly.
That's what made it weird.
Dang old pandemic.
There was this goofy idea I had to put a picture of Tony Hawk's mouth on.
Oh, I love that.
It just looked scary.
You should have done that. You should have done that anyway, because you look like a PS1 model of Tony. That's what made it perfect.
It was
authentic. Yeah,
it was bad.
Ooh.
Oh. When I would play this game, all I would do was grind. Like, I never fucked with flip tricks or board slides or anything. Like, it was just about grinding.
I thought it was so cool you could drive in this game. But it's actually, now that I'm older, not like, I don't know, 8, it kind of sucks.
I don't remember this.
What? Look, see?
I don't remember driving. What the
fuck? You don't remember it, huh? Because it was like, no. Such a small portion of the game.
Yeah, this feels like a little much to me personally. Like, do we have to drive
Midnight
a car
Club.
In Tony Hawk, you know?
It's because I think like Grand Theft Auto came out. It's like, all right, we have to have a game where you could do it all. We have to compete. We have to compete with Tommy Vercetti. We have to holy Toledo.
Yeah, get Matt Hoffman in here.
They had BMX in American Wasteland.
Right.
It was weird. That was the game where, like, they were like, yeah, it never loads. But, like, the thing is, the reason why I could never, like, you never have to do loading times was because in between each level, there's a transitional level area where all I could do is really grind. So it's like, yeah, that's
man,
why
where the fuck
it
are
load.
They taking you?
A boring hallway.
Yeah.
You're gonna get some crazy money.
Gonna get some crazy money! That's the one of the few games I'm actually good at. I fuck with Crazy Taxi hardcore. K-Zone chat
this
knows.
A little better, the graphics, I'm gonna say.
It aged well. They made it just nice enough graphic-wise for the time. Where like you see, like, Xbox 360 era, everything is, like, brown and bloomy. It's either really brown and or really bright, or both at the same time. So that era does not age well. Since you try to hit all the telephone. Alright, local skaters, Sean. Alright, so we gotta put up flyers where all the local kids are skating. Excuse me, Mike.
That's how kids respond. They respond to flyers so well.
Yeah, that's how you gotta be like get big on Twitch nowadays. You gotta put up flyers.
Perhaps there was a Tony Hawk video game now, they would be getting TikTok subscribers.
Yes, sir. Oh,
Eric Sparrow.
Oh crap, it's Chad Muska, my hero.
Oh, the creator of Muska Beats? I love Chad.
Did you know he got in trouble for spray painting the N-word on a building?
Who did?
Chad Muska. No. Yeah, oh, yes.
That sounds like BAM behavior.
BAM behavior? Yeah. Well, but you see, the thing is, BAM is that BAM has an excuse. He was wasted. Oh, he's name dropping Metallica.
American wasteland, so I guess it fits.
True, true. Oh, have you ever seen Earth Rocker? Garrett?
No, no.
Okay, wait. I'm gonna pause this. We have to show you Earth Rocker.
Please, I was.
It's a BAM video.
I was informing you earlier that I demanded the reggaeton.
Yeah. Let's, in order to have you on, we had to put on reggaeton.
Yeah, I demanded that please play. What's the name of that song? Is it? Oh, I can't.
This is incredible.
Darude.
Darude Sandstorm.
Darude Sandstorm in reggaeton format only.
Hey, you joke about me derailing a stream to show funny videos, but we, because of that, we got to show Justin Wang the Randy Stare video. All right, good things always come of this.
All right, there's a song that plays in that Randy Stare video, and I heard it at the gym the other day, and I just like couldn't separate it in my mind from the Randy Stare manifesto.
I'm not showing him the Pakistan train video where the donkey gets hit by a train. I'm not trying to lose the channel. This is a great video. Surprise.
My best friend Ryan Dunn died in a car accident 4 years ago. He's dead and gone.
Oh, bam.
Iceland's his favorite place. Never-ending
story,
I'm
going
to build him a skate park.
Yeah.
You don't have to be a musician to be an Earth Rocker. Andrew Strandberg is an Earth Rocker. My other best friend, Brandon Novak, is on heroin again. He's back in rehab for his 16th time. Good luck with that one. I'm sick of the bullshit. I'm sick of all the shit. I don't go out anymore because I hate every motherfucker. I don't care what they're up to. 4 years I wasted sipping on drinks at the bar, chit-chatting.
He's an anti-hero, guys.
Now I stay.
He's like Deadpool.
Like a fucking hermit. I'm not gonna take any shit from anyone.
He has a black eye in this, too.
I don't know where that came from.
I got set up. I got jumped.
Street
Thank God
Nikki.
Nikki wasn't there to watch me get my fucking ass kicked. She would have wound up with a black eye and then probably went to jail. She has a big mouth.
So I didn't know that the name. I love it. What was the name of this video? Fuck on.
Earth Rocker.
Earth Rocker. Yeah, I definitely like heard this audio and I think I'd seen this whole thing before, but I didn't know that this is the Earth Rocker.
It's Earth Rocker.
In quotes. God.
Payback, and the bitch motherfucker.
This is about,
why couldn't he have ended up like Bill Valla? He would have been so good at the new Jackass guys. They really fucked up.
Yeah, they should have brought him along. They could have at least gotten one good video out of Bam. Like, I feel like he had something in the tank. Wait, I got me, whatever this is. Bam Margera, I need time to stay useless trailer. No.
No, thank you.
No, thank you, Bam. I can't support your lifestyle.
Do you guys get bummed when you see the Jackass trailer that he's not in it? Because I genuinely, followed his whole rehab
oh yeah, you rooted
exploits.
For him.
Yeah, I rooted for him the whole time, like on Instagram when he was posting that insane shit, getting his car stolen and everything. The whole saga was great, but then it was like I see those Jackass commercials now and I'm like, a little tear is shed for Mr. Margera not being able
frozen.
To be with his buddies.
Yeah, I noticed Chad that too, but I mean, I don't know. All this stuff I hear coming out from BAM, it's just kind of like, I don't know, you gotta get this fixed, because you can't expect other people to put you in a fucking movie if you're acting like this.
No, this happened for a reason, but it is just like, he couldn't get the deal.
He couldn't get it. And yo. Oh, thank you, Chad Muska. Thanks. BAM would never give me a skateboard. What I love about this game is that it takes place, like, when it was made, it took place in the point in time when the coolest car you could own was an Escalade. That was a period of time. You're
in. Like, yeah. the mid to
oh,
late
Oh shit, two
2000s.
Whole years of extortion.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
no
you,
Teslas
Kelly.
Back then.
Like, if you played, like, Need for Speed Underground 1 or 2, like, you'd have all these, like, cool cars you could drive, all these cool cars you could buy, and all the drive in that game, and then they'd have the slow-ass Escalade, just because it was what was cool. And it would just, it just had this spectacularly bad car stat-wise in the game, just because
my
it was cool.
My sub has lasted as long as the pandemic.
You could fit the most subwoofers in the back of an Escalade, though, man.
I know, it, that's why, it's cool.
You gotta be able to put up big numbers. You gotta make that thing bump. Yeah.
Alright, Jack, watch this. Alright, all you do is get this watch. Alright, one combo.
20,000 points in one combo?
Yes, sir.
It can't be done.
I could do it. Oh, no, my neck!
Oh, man.
You had it, though. You had 27.
What if this game was really realistic and immediately after bailing like that, I just, like, had a seizure?
I mean, it should be. That'd be fucking awesome.
like how Mortal Kombat got super realistic with the like X-ray vision during.
Oh fatality. My God! Yeah, there was a football
was
video
game
that did
that.
That.
Yeah,
it
would
was Blitz.
Zoom in on like bone crunching impact.
And like there was this one like it showed cutscene the bone breaking, and there was Ooh. This one cutscene that where if they ruptured your testicles, it would zoom into your testicles. And it would explode.
Dude, they need this guy like flopping around, you know, like zoom in on his brain, firing synapses. He's stroking out. He's drooling.
They hired a like just like how if like The Last of Us, they hired people that to like watch like our best gore stuff just for research. They hired a bunch of like offensive linemen that had a 3-year football career before they started stroking out. It's like, all right, we need to do research. What did you feel?
I see somebody in the chat here said Simpsons Hit and Run with realistic car crash, and that's something I would pay to see. I would play the hell out of that.
Bart! Our son, Bart Simpson, is dead.
Yeah,
because
Bart's
Jake
trachea was crushed by his father.
Yeah.
Bart got hit by Mr. Burns while he was skateboarding, and then he had a seizure.
The Canyonero was traveling at 75 miles per hour when Lisa was beheaded.
By Krusty the Clown. Krusty the Clown is canceled.
Somebody says Bart getting donkey trained. Now that would be that'd be a hell of a finale.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how would you guys finish off The Simpsons?
I mean, if that would be a B plot for the episode for sure, like Bart just turning into red powder after getting hit by a train. Otherwise, Maggie says her first. Well, I guess she already spoke once, but
did
she,
they speak? Yeah,
she said her fourth word.
Yeah, she says her fourth word, and then that's a hell of a finale right there. I knew you were Jersey local. Probably at like Bart's
fourth
funeral.
Word.
Bart's funeral. Season 55, episode 26. Bart's funeral.
Man.
A dead
so
Bart
that'll
theory.
Come one day.
Yeah, Bart's funeral. Yeah, we all die one day, Garrett.
What? you're making me get existential, but I'm thinking just like the last episode of The Simpsons will come one day, and like Marge's fat fucking special trick slot, it won't live up to the hype.
I think a decent amount of people are going to try to pretend it's good.
Well,
it can't.
It's there's so much writing on it. It won't be good.
They're going to bring in, like, every classic writer. Like, Conan's going to come back. They're going to have, like, 30 guys writing one episode, and it's going to be completely incoherent.
It goes to show
it's
you...
it's going to be too much shoved into too tight of a time slot.
Oh. Do you have even feel paint? Damn, dude. Oh, my God.
Damn, dude.
Well, that easy. What I was going to say is, like, it goes to show you that, like, even if you went to Harvard, like, just because you went to Harvard does not mean you're smart and or creative. Like, the entire Simpsons writing staff, all Harvard. And they brag about it all the time.
I mean, the original classic crew was, like, funny, but the people who went to Harvard who come out of there now and are ripe for The Simpsons, not so hot.
No.
Harvard-era SNL had some highlights. I'll give him that, but...
I think nowadays SNL just kind of write... They let Twitter write the jokes for them.
Oh, the Elmo. We got... Yeah, we should mention Elmo, yeah.
That was brutal.
left it on the front
just
porch.
Whatever piece of shit Pete Davidson wants to do.
Looks
this
like
week
I'm gonna have to sneak,
yeah, for real.
You know what, people say that they let people hit Pete Davidson because he's goofy. I don't think he's that goofy. I just think he looks weird.
Yeah, he's like try hard goofy. He's got like a stylist that makes him goofy.
He's like, my generation, it would be that kid that watched, like, that funny fat kid, that epic fat kid, that would watch Drake and Josh and try to be Josh Peck. Although, that's better than being Drake Bell.
Yeah, I was gonna say
he would
that.
Do...
Is it both,
He's goofy for New York City. He's goofy for, like, Brooklyn. But, like, at an anime convention, he's, like, the hottest dude in the room. And the
right,
most well-dressed.
Yeah, he's normal at an anime con. Like, if he's like, they're inviting him to Kingdom Hearts-themed orgies, and he's like,
oh my god,
a little too much for me.
He's Sigma. He shows up at a fucking panel, and, like,
grab
no one
button,
in the
it?
Room can
I forgot,
compete.
I forgot which one the grab button was. Let me just check. The... Yeah,
this is the best part of the game. Not the skating, but the...
Hold on. Wait a minute. Control setup. No walking. What is it going to do when I do this?
Just like T-pose and float around?
You just run? I guess you're
R1,
running.
R1, okay.
Huh.
There
helping
we go.
Us out.
I guess I couldn't grab that ledge immediately. Okay.
Oh, shout out to Gluminati in the chat. That's a friend of both Garrett's and I. He says Pete Davidson is in a butt ugly Martians cosplay.
Ack. He's always wearing that.
That is accurate. That is very accurate.
Oh, wait. Control setup. I got to turn back on walking because that's going to screw me up and I'm going to forget I put turn that on.
You don't want to run everywhere?
No. You can't even really walk. This is like slight tap right here. Slight love tap right here.
That's a little analog tilt there.
And a little half an A press.
I keep forgetting.
Oh, and
you're
I'm
Mars.
Sorry. Shout out to Grant Mooney in the chat too. He's mad
Oops,
that I didn't
what?
Shout him out.
I would be mad as well. I'm mad for a different reason. Grant said he was going to be sitting here next to me, like you are, Kevin.
Oh, Grant, if you'd like to come in, man, I'll send you the invite real quick.
It's funny, boys. This whole thing got started after like a brief Twitter interaction, which is how most of my collabs get started, I think.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. This has already been fun. This has been like
well,
2,
I
30
thank
minutes.
You for reaching out.
I am a bit of a quote unquote go getter of these kind of things because like I would never reach out to someone unless I thought I could vibe with them. And I always loved your work, and I've always. Actually, wait. One second. I just had an idea. All right. I want you to listen to this voice line real quick.
Okay. Spur of the moment voice line.
Wait, kid. It's dangerous. One more time. Wait, kid. It's too dangerous. All right. I want you to do an impression of that.
He's very nasally. He's like congested and he doesn't really. Pronounce dangerous. It's like dangerous. Okay, ready?
Yes.
You can count me in. Okay.
All right, ready? Go.
Yeah. Wait, kid, it's dangerous.
There we go.
Oh, it's too dangerous. Wait, kid, it's too dangerous.
Perfect. Bellissimo. Yeah.
That's where I get the big bucks. Non-union voice acting credits, baby.
Exactly. All right, ready? We're going to steal from Jay and Silly Bob.
Eric? Hey, what are you doing here? Well,
awesome.
This is why Eric's the worst.
You get back to Peralta's before you get caught.
Yeah, Eric.
What's he going to do?
Me?
He's like Jersey's Skunky Beaumont. He's just like the little Eddie Haskell, the rat bastard of a neighborhood, huh?
Yeah, oh my god.
What?
This guy's seen a little too Beavis and Butt, or too much Beavis and Butthead, methinks.
Yeah. This is fucked up. This hunched
this
over.
This is what
gremlin.
They do in Jersey, bro?
This when you go to like Newark or like Edison, this is all that goes on. Also, Johnny Peralta's there.
What's going on here?
Marge Simpson's there. Stacy
Peralta? That's me.
That's the secret Simpson state. What do you guys think the secret Simpson state is?
Like
sponsored by where it takes place?
Yeah, the secret like Simpsons state.
Well, you know it's not a secret anymore. They confirmed it.
What?
Show me what yeah,
is
like,
it Illinois?
It was like, no, we believe me, I wish. No, Matt Groening said it was Oregon, because he grew up in Oregon, and there is a Springfield, Oregon, and I guess, I don't know how relevant it really has to be, because it just really is every town in America. Like, it pulls from, like, all different kinds of, you know, parts of the country, so.
Just like Tony Hawk's Underground pulls
exactly.
From all walks of life.
Like, you take a look at this town here, and you're like, yep, I recognize that.
I grew up here.
Okay. Chad Muska swings by. He throws his flavor in.
Chad Muska's a local.
Oh, he's from here.
Oh.
Eric, you okay?
Oops. Oh, no. Oh, can't show that on TV.
It's kind of throwing me off how the command prompt is the same font at the end of the dialogue. So I keep waiting for somebody to say, like, press X to continue every time they finish their sentence.
Speaking of commands, Twitch commands. Yeah!
But if we bring him some scrap metal, he says there's some interesting information in the chat right here. I'm seeing.
Yeah.
Oh, shout
out! Yourself learned.
Killer DLS in the chat as well. Hello.
I guess you have a Chris Benoit bot. It looks like.
Moobot. You could put anything. I also have. Bodega.
And factual.
The AOC tweet. This is the Kazon secret menu.
Wait, is that really one of her tweets?
Yeah.
Como va?
Oh, you just know that you love when you go into a bodega and someone's playing Oye Como va for their backpack speaker. This is real New York. I need there we go, chat box.
You know, popular culture has driven me to start using the word bodega. In California, it's a liquor
bodega.
Store. No one calls it a bodega. But I've been doing that, and people will give me the fucking dirtiest looks. Like, they don't like it. I'm like, yo, guys, I'm going to the bodega. What do you want? And they're looking at me like,
give me a chopped cheese.
Hey, it's called a 7-Eleven.
You think you're from... You think you're not from San Diego?
Ah! Ah! Stop!
Oh, you there, Serb?
Yeah, I'm there. Guys, don't do that again.
What happened?
Yeah, Kevin and I are a bit in the.
I was concerned.
Here.
I was like, did he fall out of his chair?
No. Let me get rid of this browser source. It played. I know I added that. I thought I got rid of it. Let's get rid of the browsers. Oh, it's this browser source? It doesn't go away. I thought... No, this is like an unwelcome demon. I can't get rid of it.
I mean, I can't hear... Garrett, can you hear this?
No. It played a loud anime noise. Well, people have to pay for it, so...
I thought that was you.
No!
Oh, we thought you were, like, going Super Saiyan for a second there, right, Kev?
No!
Yeah.
I thought you were doing like a Demon Slayer bit.
No! Don't! No, seriously, don't do that.
You gotta get to control your chat, man.
No, it's like getting a site.
To pay him.
It's like, I will earn money from that, but it's like, is it worth it? No.
Okay, so the Gloominati, Killer DLS confirms, I guess they didn't hear Streamlabs, a loud Japanese lady was screaming. Yeah, I definitely missed that.
That sounds...
Because, I'm just on the screen here on Discord, so I'm a little,
Yeah, it was, I forgot the name of the anime girl, because I know who it is. Oh, Karen Cujo, yeah, fucking Karen Cujo, fucking yelling at
fucking
me.
Karen.
Fucking Karens.
Classic Karen.
Was she like, itadakimasu?
Always. She's always saying that. That's.
And she's calling the police too, right away.
Always.
Did it sound like that? Did it sound like, itadakimasu?
kicking my ass.
Yes.
No problem. I hate that, man. But you know, if they're donating for it, then you try to clear the bridge. Let them go crazy.
Well,
oh, are you skitching? It's time to skitch.
Yeah, we're skitching.
Skitching on that CRX.
Oh my god, it's still burning. It's still burning. Oh shit, wait. We do this.
What?
Oops. I was going the wrong... Bad angle. 5-0.
Did you hit an invisible wall?
No, I hit a cop. I was going to go right into the water. I was going to die, Garrett. I was going to die.
You hear that, Kev? You hit a cop. A cap, baby.
Oh, boy.
It's a problematic stream you got me on here, man. He's hitting cops.
I... Well, the street punks are up to something again. Always.
All right, here we go. Unlocked.
New zone. But we gotta get inside the train station.
What is this, the factory? Or what are some other classic Tony Hawk stages? The schoolyard?
Yeah. There's like two schools.
Always a school. Yeah. Those are always the best spots to skate.
The school? What's your favorite Tony Hawk level?
What's your problem, bacon bits?
Tony Hawk, this morning? I'm trying to think, like, maybe the school in the... Well, no, actually, Balboa Park, I think, in Tony Hawk 3. Because it was, like, a local spot.
Okay.
I'll say that. If I had to pick one. I forget which one. It was either 2 or 3 had...
I can just
Balboa
bail over
Park
and over.
In San Diego.
What was the
I just killed
that
guy.
One in Tony Hawk 3 where it was like there was like a furnace or something. There was like some like vat of lava you could go over.
Yeah, the foundry.
Those
started
cool.
Getting crazy. The foundry, the
I like the cruise ship.
Area 51 had the UFO you could make take off.
Yeah, Roswell, I think, right?
I like the cruise ship.
all that shit.
Oh yeah, the cruise ship from Tony Hawk 3.
The NeverSoft girls that talk to me. That every time a girl talks to me, she sounds like the NeverSoft girls from the cruise ship because it's vaguely condescending. Like, you're doing great. It's like, oh, sick, dude.
Good job.
Good job. There's my special little guy.
I'll take it.
Looking good, my dude. I'll give
you a train ticket. Oh, Ollie the Bum is back.
I didn't know the unhoused were represented in this game. How?
Ollie the Magic Bum is representation.
Were you guys, I can't remember, Garrett, do you remember if Ollie the Bum was in the remakes or not?
Yeah, he was, I think.
Because I remember being like...
Oh, it's in one combo.
I remember that was the one thing I was like, I wonder if that's going to come back.
Yeah, I because you had to ollie over him in different spots. Yeah, if I remember correctly, in the level down by, it's kind of based off of, Oh, what's that hippie fucking dirty beach down in LA?
Venice?
Oh, God. Venice, yeah, that dirty, slimy, grungy,
okay,
disgusting.
That's where Ollie made
town.
His.
Venice Beach.
That's where Ollie made his debut. The iconic Ollie the Magic Bum.
I just played those two, the remakes, and I.
So
I
good.
Believe, yeah, that was in Tony Hawk 2, down at that Venice level. But I don't remember if they called him Ollie or not. And then they brought back the security guard that would chase you.
Officer
Although
Dick.
This time it was voiced. Yeah, Officer Dick was voiced by... Well, I don't know if it was Officer Dick. It was just a security guard in the school level. But it was voiced by... I swear to God, it was...
Clint Eastwood?
No. It was the other half of Tenacious D that's not Kyle Gass. Why can't I think of Jack Black's name? There we go.
I was going to say, I thought you were going to say the guy
Jack
who wasn't
Black. Oh, I killed Eric.
No, I remember Kyle Gass's name in a pinch, but not the fucking guy I need.
Not Nacho Libre.
The guy
no,
who's playing Bowser?
Oh, right.
You know what horrible movie I saw recently? Epic movie.
Epic movie. Was that like from 2008 or something?
Yeah. Like, because in the very beginning, one of the first scenes, they parody Nacho Libre. And they have Kumar from Harold and Kumar in it. Those movies were a really weird time in human history.
Oh man,
yeah.
We We did a rewatch of Meet the Spartans
in
November.
We're gonna go see Juno.
It was fucking, it was torture. But we were stuck in the van, like driving through Texas, and it's like, let's fucking, we picked this up at a flea market. Let's watch Meet the Spartans.
Oh my
God. I don't even remember how bad this is. It was so fucking bad.
Even at the time, aged like milk.
Yeah, it was just like, you can't make a movie like that because it's gonna age.
That movie came out like Benjamin fucking Button. It was aged 90 fucking years.
Oh. Epic movie was probably, if I could imagine, along those lines. But that had to be the worst, because I think, like, Scary Movie and those other, the Wayans Brothers ones, those are all right. I don't remember, like...
Well, those were the original ones. No, but yeah. Then they started getting off, like, and then not another teen movie. That was funny, too, if I recall.
I feel like there's some gems in that.
The thing is that the original crew left, and it was just two college friends left over. And they made,
money.
And they made all of those movies.
There's Date Movie, Epic Movie, Meet the Spartans. Maybe there might have been one more, but I think that reception, like, I it might have been Epic Movie. I think that was the one that was the final straw, where people were like, "We as a collective society have to eradicate this from, like, our culture. Like, this is so bad. It's so offensively stupid.
We've gone over the line. Full circle." Time to end it.
I remember, like, when that movie came out, a couple of friends of mine, like, got, they were at the movie theater. They, like, convinced the movie theater mat, because I think we were, like, in high school or something. They convinced the movie theater manager to, like, give them a refund because the movie was so bad, and they agreed to it, and they sat through the whole thing too. They're just like, okay, fine.
I actually,
here's your money back.
I witnessed, like, when I was going through Tubi, which, like, you know, oh, free service, free movies, yeah, whatever. I discovered the worst movie of that genre that wasn't even made by the, like, movie people. It was called The Hungover Games. And it was capitalizing on The Hangover's popularity and The Hunger Games' popularity. And in the movie, one of the references was one of the bad guys they had to kill for The Hungover Games was Ted. But Ted was always naked, and Ted had
like
a big penis.
The teddy bear?
Yes, Ted the teddy bear had a huge penis the entire movie that is just dangling out. It
I don't
is,
care who you are, that's funny.
I don't care who you are, that is funny. I helped
Adult
the student.
Swim doesn't want it, we'll put it on Tubi.
Yeah. I don't care.
Do you guys remember the slap chop maniac? Like, I think a prostitute bit his tongue off or some nonsense. But do you remember the slap chop guy?
Right, no.
Thanks, so.
My.
Good job. The slap chop guy would sell on infomercials this device that would, like, dice up, like, vegetables and stuff for salsa. But then he funded one of those
ISIS
movies, like one of those, like, Kentucky Fried Movie or, like, Not Another Teen movies. I can't remember what it was, but
was he like a British guy?
Anthony Sullivan.
Yeah, Anthony Sullivan, right.
Wait, he got his fucking, like, tongue bit off by a prostitute?
Something crazy. Wait, maybe he's... No, Anthony Sullivan's, like, he's, like, a better version of the slap chop guy. The slap chop guy was, like, lower tier, you know.
I was just wondering. I was just like, oh, my God.
Anthony's up there with, like, Billy Mays, you
and
know,
the ShamWow guy.
He's, like, regarded. He's a good guy. Yeah, they like cocaine, but they're good guys, you know?
Well, you gotta stay that way in order to make it in the industry.
Oh, you know, someone in the chat here mentioned movie 43. That was a kind of... I think that might have been the last one of those, like...
My dad loves that movie and has always tried to make me watch it. What's
wrong with people? So I think that was the one that the slap chop guy was, like, trying to promote. Vince Offer is the dude's name. Vince Offer.
I thought you were...
Go ahead. He did ShamWow as well. He sold ShamWow and the Slap Chop.
After the ShamWow guy went to jail. I remember that being, like, a big thing. I remember there, like, being, like, a rumor back in, like, elementary school. The guy in the Barney suit, like, diddled kids and he got arrested or something. Or that, like, Steve from Blue's Clues killed a guy while drunk driving.
Blue's Clues dude killed himself.
Yeah, there was a lot of recess rumors regarding the Blue's Clues guy. I also remember the scariest thing to, like, kids in my elementary school would be Michael Jackson. They'd be like, oh, Michael, I'm so scared of Michael Jackson coming to get me.
Yeah, I remember that.
Would you hear
valid.
When they put out that thing,
Kmart's having a special.
Oh.
When I was young, seriously, the rumors were like that he slept in a hyperbaric chamber, that he had the animal, the elephant what was it? The elephant man's bones. That was a definite rumor. Because I remember liking Michael Jackson in elementary school. It was the jam, dude. And then,
yeah.
No one was allowed to like Michael Jackson in elementary school.
This was this was pre Culkin or, you know, any allegations into the kid diddling. He was merely just a weirdo who had vitiligo and then slept inside a pressure chamber or something. I remember being like, no way he sleeps in a pressure chamber. Little did we know what was really going on.
Yeah, we didn't know.
Yeah, I would rather that have been the case.
Yeah.
Hey, I would
man,
rather
collect
that.
The animal, collect the elephant man's bones, sleep inside a fucking pressurized coffin.
Who wouldn't
whatever
like
you
that?
Want.
That'd be sick. Oh man, he's got this guy's bones. Oh, that's
yeah,
cool.
Then he started eating those Subway
sleepovers,
sandwiches.
You know? Oh yeah, the Subway shit, man. I was gonna say you guys had that really funny bit at your live show with the Jared compilation.
Yeah, that always gets a good laughter once the Jared Subway commercials start airing on the screen.
You ever see that DC Comics crossover of Jared the Subway Guy?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Where they're just like, "Thank you, Jared. We couldn't have done it without you."
There's so much like that, and I think that's what's so fun about showing those old commercials, because there's so many weird instances in the commercial that just out of context now you're like, oh no, don't go in there, Jared's. Oh no.
Yeah, a lot of kids.
He's talking to those children. No,
get him away. What was so bad? You see, what made it even more evil was the fact that he was a weight loss hero. So you know he was going from school to school based on that. I think that's probably why he got caught, because he was like doing
actually,
so many like tours and stuff where it's like anyone could do it. You can't be a fat kid anymore.
So I used to work at Subway a while back.
You were a sandwich artist.
Yes, I was a sandwich artist, and my boss was like this the short Italian American guy with a bad temper, but he proudly had this like big photo of him shaking hands with Jared up behind the register. And I remember right before I left there was when the Jared thing happened. And I remember
that's when you knew you had to go.
Well, yeah. he told me because like they told all the franchisees before the news broke, and he was just like, I gotta tell you something, I got some bad news. And then he told me the whole like Jared thing. And then we had like promotional.
So you knew
material.
Before any of us.
Yeah. Like hours before. But we had like, you know, the promotional material like up on the, you know, like you gotta look up and order the sandwiches and everything. They got the list of sandwiches, and there was like pictures of Jared up there, and then he tells me all this stuff. And then he pulls out this ladder and like sets it in front of me, and he's like, "Now get up there and take that sick fuck off my wall." And, like, he crumpled up the picture of him and Jared,
hell
like
yeah.
Threw it in the trash, and he was like sitting in the lobby. Like he looked like he was about to cry. Like it was like, a 60,
he was
this,
betrayed.
Like, 60-year-old, he like the slick back hair and everything. And he just was out there, just like so fucking furious.
Oh,
that's awesome. That's better than all the other retail stories I hear that are just depressing. I was just like, yeah, so I saw this guy like have a mental breakdown because Jared diddled kids.
I mean, like, shit like that happened too, but I have this like vivid memory of like crumpling up a big Jared poster and tossing it in the trash and then seeing it all over the news the rest of the day.
If you don't crumple up this picture, it's gonna be you on the news next, Kevin!
Yo, not me! It was just like,
hi, honey,
yeah,
how was work? Not a good day, Diane. Not a good day, got some bad news. Luckily, Kevin was there to help me through.
And he was like a shorter guy, too, so that's why he like just like pulls this ladder out, and he's like, I'll never forget like him pointing out and like, take that sick fuck off of my wall.
Hey, you know what, kid's godfather? You know what, kid's godfather? Well, I got some bad news.
The gods are tough, but I heard they like...
Oh, my God.
Oh, we get to make our own trick.
After that.
I've been a Jimmy John's guy ever since. Kevin Harvick of NASCAR will never do anything wrong.
Nah.
I remember, even before the Jared stuff happened, like, whenever we'd all have to put out the Jared stuff in the restaurant, we'd always be like, doesn't something seem off about him? Like, it was, like, something in his smile.
Yeah, whenever we had to put out treats for Jared before he came out for his promos.
Yeah, like, because he kind of asked for all this weird stuff, like candy and everything.
A virgin child and candy.
I want to say, too, right around that same time.
Talking about hot dogs and pizza.
He was weirdly combative about age of consent laws.
Do you guys remember Sharknado 3 when they had a Jared cameo?
Yeah.
Oh.
So I remember that.
On every little table in the lobby at that same time, we also had these little, those little triangle pamphlets at restaurants and fast food places. And the ad was this picture of, of Jared. Like, it was like he was holding a 6-inch sub, but it was like a sandwich, or it was like a toy shark he was about to take a bite out of. So obviously I had to take all those and throw them away too. But
oh, thank you, Blueberry Tart.
I think the Jared stuff, the Sharknado 3 came out like a week or two before the Jared news broke. So they had to pull that movie. So there's a Jared Fogel cut of Sharknado 3, which you can look up on YouTube for the deleted Jared scenes. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, Zack Snyder, eat your heart out. In the original Snyder cut, they actually adapted the scene from that one DC comic where they say, "Thank you, Jared. We couldn't have done it without you."
Yeah, it was black and white, technically 4:3 aspect ratio. They pulled him out of prison for that one. Actually, they were like, Jared,
we gotta break him out. I need you guys for a heist. One last job. We're breaking Jared. All right. Would you guys like to make a trick with me?
Yes.
All right. Earlier, I made one trick where it was just a spin that took 3 seconds.
Very slow.
And I couldn't land it
Marge
once.
Simpson.
Yeah. Let's do a simp spin. All right.
Oh,
rotation.
I like that. That's on brand.
Toe
Marge
side
simp
roll.
Spin.
Let's do a 180. Wait. Let's make these all really short. Wait. I got the idea.
You're very inverted here.
Look at that. And then we'll
do
another.
You gotta be able to land it too.
Back front flip. Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh no! Not 180.
Oh, wow. Land upside down?
Yeah, well, let's grab two.
Homie, I'm so dizzy.
Homie! Our son Bart's been talking with a weird guy on CSGO. He's asking him to buy him knee socks. Marge.
Oh, no. Wasn't there an episode recently where, Bart did become a streamer?
Oh, no. He played CSGO with Martin and all of his school friends.
Okay.
That's kind of like a boomer shooter. That's funny.
No, not CSGO. He was playing League. All right, there we go.
Okay.
This is simp spin.
I'm thinking of Source.
The simp spin.
The simp spin. Not Buster. No.
No, come on.
Marge would never name a trick that.
Yeah, I am a moderator of the Simpsons Wiki. Let me tell you, we don't fuck with that.
Oh, Serb, I've been meaning to ask you, because I think you might see this guy on Twitter as well. Who is that guy who is obsessed with...
The Simpsons women. Females. The Simpsons females disapprove. The Simpsons female look on in awe to the Megalodon.
Garrett, you got to see this if you haven't. I don't remember the guy's name offhand. Do you, Serb?
I don't.
But it's this guy on Twitter. He, it's truly insane. He's obsessed with...
The Simpsons women.
Simpsons women
as ninjas.
Yeah, as ninjas. So he has commissions and draws people to draw all like Lisa is second grade teacher dressed as a ninja and Marge Simpson dressed as a ninja.
What kind of ninja? Like Snake Eyes from G.I. Joe?
It's actually like really non-sexual looking though. Which I don't know if that makes it better or worse.
But that's a good point. Wow. Like I would almost rather it be like a weird fetish thing because I don't really know how to read this otherwise.
I hate those like over-sexualized toon
ninjas
images, like where they sexy up Lois from Family Guy.
Oh, those are always weird. Oh, I have his account. It's right here. Ben Hughes.
Ben Hughes. It's at Ben Hugh 264-22354. And he's got
some this isn't good. Really... All right, hold on. I'm gonna stream this to you, Garrett. This is I'm gonna stream this to the chat as well. For the VOD. Right here. This is what we're looking at.
Oh, that Ben Hughes. Ah, I'm following the very same. Okay. Yeah.
I know like 5 different Ben Hugheses, but this is a different one.
Wow.
The Simpsons females stared in amazement at Gangsta SpongeBob.
Man, wow. There's all the ninja stuff.
Yeah, that's him as a Simpson. That's him as a Simpson and also as a ninja.
Dude,
Raphael TFNT tells Squidward to shut up and threatens to take Squidward's head and Homer Simpson cheers at Rat.
I love adult animation.
Yeah. I won't take your hand and smash it against the. Wait, this is how he's editing it together?
Yes.
I thought that was you for a second. I'm like,
no.
Oh, he's just. But this is my favorite thing. Is he has this like insane collage of all of them on the left side, and they're always staring at someone. But like,
oh, it's a double chat overlay.
Why are there so many screens he's compiled of? It's not even just main characters.
Everyone that's ever been a woman on The Simpsons.
As long as you're a female. Yep. Wow.
The Simpsons female stared in amazement at me.
Fucking king shit. What?
It is. Yeah. He is.
This guy's.
The Simpsons
not compromising.
I like this one. Just because of how verbose it is. The Simpsons female stared in amazement at Ankylosaurus, an armor-plated dinosaur armor that lived in the Great Cretaceous period, 68 to 66 million years ago, in Western North America.
I mean, this is just like some innocent thing. His caretaker probably is like, well, he's not hurting anybody. You know, it's the guy who, or the people who watch over like BB.
Exactly.
It's like, you know, if he's posting about Pepsi and that's it, that's fine. Maybe he has a weird.
Maybe people are like, yo. But, like, no one's gang-stalking him.
Right, and thank God. And they really shouldn't. You know, we gotta protect Ben Hughes at all costs.
At all costs.
Ben Hughes is
a
sweetie.
You're gonna have a hard time following him.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you can't find the right guy. You can't find the right guy. There's a lot of Ben Hugheses, and sorry to say, there's a lot of Ben Hugheses that Simpsons females are staring in amazement of. So, crowded market.
Well, yeah.
Like, Bad for Health in the chat says, the Simpsons females are gang-stalking me.
Simpsons female ninjas are gang-stalking me. Click here. All right, so let's see. What else we got to do
with
Eeyore?
That may just be the end game of this whole thing, you know?
Where's the other... where are my goals? Oh, Gap the Burning Taxi.
You know. That taxi.
There it is. Thank you, Eric. I think Eric did it.
Eric's all right. Fire, once right?
Wait.
I love the countdown to get back on your board.
Ah, the traffic. They're in the way.
Goddamn DC truck.
Yeah, there's a big industry here for that. Apparently, I've seen 15 trucks DC. All right, hold on. I gotta get the momentum.
You gotta line.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
Oh,
and I could stack the tricks right here. Oh, tree.
Oh, fucking tree.
Fuck you. This is why. You know what? Cut them all down. Ah.
Don't even make paper. Just cut them down.
I stack paper. All right.
Burn it.
There we go. Nose grab. Melon. Then we can do a heel flip.
Land it.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. Trick over the burning taxi.
All right, here we go. I don't get enough air. I need to level up my air, I think. But how? Oh, yeah, Alex Ortega, number one Simpsons fan.
I was trying to Google him earlier today, too. I forgot there was a reason I was trying to, but I was looking for that guy. I just, like, I was Googling, like, biggest Simpsons collector, and then it just kept showing pictures of comic book guy.
Well, that's because he's real.
Right, but there's that, yeah, that's his name, right? The guy who, like, basically his entire house is nothing but, like, Simpsons memorabilia.
Yeah, Alex Ortega.
I don't have a lot of room to talk. Like, I have, like, in my bedroom, I have, like, 30 World of Simpsons, like, Springfield character figurines I bought when I was in middle school that are now coming in handy. What was that?
Oh, that's cool, though.
Hey, man.
Yeah, yeah. They're just, you know, cool figurines. Well, but, you know, they stare at me. They watch me. They watch over me.
I just spent $40 on a Jim Cornette autograph figure who's a wrestling personality. Tampa. Because on the autograph it said "Fuck you, Donald Trump" on it, and I was like, "That's a really funny thing to have on as part of an autograph."
Do what makes you happy, sir. For the trip,
but tell me what you want to ride, and I'll send you all the free gear you need for the event, dude.
It's all decor. This guy's whole apartment just happens to be Simpsons themed.
I'm jealous of the fact that you know Danhausen, Garrett.
Oh. Well, very, very spooky, very evil Danhausen has blessed us with a couple little videos. Yeah, they are sharp, I tell you.
Yeah, I was going to say, wasn't he like, didn't he come by the studio or do something with you guys at some point?
He hasn't come by the studio. I haven't actually met the dude. It's like Johnny and Derek have talked with him a couple times and gotten him to do some videos for some of our streams, some of our live streams Twitch before. But I haven't to meet him yet. I'm hoping AEW signs him. I've been getting like way.
Oh, are you with AEW?
AEW.
I am very in right AEW. Now. Who's your guys?
Yeah, I'm like all sucked in again.
Who's your
right
boys
now?
In AEW?
I really like what I think the reason I started watching was because they got CM Punk and.
Oh, that was when I started
Brian
watching
Danielson.
Too.
Yeah, great signings. So when those two guys came in. I'm like, all right, what's going on? And then, like, Johnny and Derek, they kind of, like, laid it out. They're like, all right, this dude, MJF, his fucking, here's his gimmick, here's this guy.
Oh, I love MJF.
I love a deep gimmick, so, like, yeah, I'm a MJF fan. This guy's, like,
I saw him in Long Island. It was awesome.
He's bad news. He's, you know, Johnny keeps telling me he stays heel, and he never breaks kayfabe. Like, even at signings and talking to people, he'll,
did
like,
you ever see the video? Did you ever see the video where, like, he flipped off, like, an 8-year-old?
I've seen that. I've seen that when I've been watching, yeah. Like, people in the front row wearing fucking AEW shirts, and he's, like, ripping up their autograph paper and throwing it back in their face. It's like, oh, bro.
It's so good. I gotta do a flip trick, wait.
The level of acting in this All Elite Wrestling, Kevin, it's up there.
You know, I've never been too into wrestling, but I feel like the way that somebody described it to me recently kind of piqued my interest, where they said it was wrestling is a lot like a shonen battle anime.
Oh yeah.
Is that accurate?
Yeah. Especially if heel Danielson. Yeah, sure. Danielson versus Paige. Very good.
Like, yeah, I got a big match. Soft spot for the Shonen Battle series, but, you know, if it's kind of capturing that same energy, that's the one thing where I was kind of like, okay, I could see myself
giving
that a shot.
It is. Like, MJF versus Punk is that. Because MJF runs away.
Yeah, and everything I knew from before was, like, you know, old WWF or WWE stuff.
Okay.
And this new promotion, honestly, like, and it's not that new. It's been around forever, but
it's getting its footing now.
They're blading, they're cutting, and they're fucking bleeding all over the place. Like, there's like gnarly shit from backyard wrestling influences, and they air this on television, which is
really
surprising. Some of the gore that is in this, like,
they swear
I saw
now.
A dude's arm get folded totally backwards.
Are you talking about Rey Fénix?
Oh yeah, that
that was
apparently
awful.
He's all right.
Yeah, he's gonna be gone a while.
They're swearing a lot more. It's just definitely like it's an evolved form.
Well,
there's a lot of like the Japanese influence, the Spanish influence, like the lucha stuff.
Oh, you'd love Kenny Omega, Kevin. He actually plays.
I'm familiar with him. Let me see.
Like the it showed and stuff. He came out as Sans during their Halloween thing.
He does. So many of the guys and gals play video games, and all their moves are named after video game shit. And like
his finishing move's called the One Wing Angel.
Yeah,
oh, for real.
Yeah.
For real.
Kenny's is, yeah.
That's cool. That's cool. I feel like a lot of athletes, you know, because as you know, that kind of, you know, anime and stuff has become more popular. It's just like it seems like every player in the NFL now is like an otaku of some kind.
Right. It's wiggled its ways into like normie culture now.
Evil,
yeah.
Evil Uno of the Dark Order. His original gimmick was Player Uno, and he was billed as from the Mushroom Kingdom, which is just so awesome. It's so stupid that that just is awesome.
And it goes all the way down to being cool, yeah.
And then he actually is a cool guy, so I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna make fun of that. I'm just gonna call that awesome. They have Brian Pillman Jr., whose dad was a wrestler.
The ladies' matches, too. Like,
Britt Baker's great. Riho's great.
Yeah. Ruby, Soho. There's a lot of good talent.
I saw...
But they need Danhausen.
They need Danhausen. Danhausen, if we ever one day cross paths, we could tell you something. Evil guy to evil guy, I respect you.
Get him on the stream.
No, he's too high roller. Even though he's indie, he's
no way. You got me and Kevin here. What
yeah, you got me for crying out loud. Wow.
I would love to get Danhausen on. I will get Dan. Yeah. All right. Fine. I will get Danhausen.
What kind of a cop move was that?
A game is this?
Put on the neck.
They have a Jeb Bush reference. Cops push Mongo. Even though I made my guy push Mongo. It's not our car,
man. I borrowed it. Oh, like that's cops. Painful.
There's a Jeb Bush reference in this level. Fighting real crime, like figuring
out where that missing sprinkled donut went. Wait, Jeb? Oh, a fan of iPhone?
Yeah.
Apple Watch? MacBook goodbye. Pro, baby? That is, unless your buddy here wants to do
us some favors. Uh-oh.
What? Is that a sexual,
Yeah, what the hell is...
Bribery? What is...
I could find something sexual with cops in this level. Just one second. I know, an Easter egg! Damn. I know an Easter egg!
Or is this like hot coffee or something?
Yeah. Officer Dick's getting cornholed back here. What's going on?
He's fucking a goat!
Well, he's dancing. I mean,
you gotta be looking at it
position
from the right
yourself.
Angle, but...
Yeah, yeah. Position yourself in front of the goat. There you go. There you go.
Oh, ew! Oh, ew! Yucky!
That's so
doing.
Gross, dude.
Ew.
Mayor Jed.
Come on, that's worse than Richard Gere and the Gerbil.
This was made like early thousands, so like they were still heated about Jeb Bush and the election. Then jump while riding to
Wally and access Jed. Hard
to... Yeah.
Is that? Yeah. Is that supposed to? Be... Yeah.
That is supposed to be Jeb.
Was he a mayor before he ran for
No,
president?
He was governor, but like this is their way of like being tongue in cheek.
Ah.
You'll see it become a little more ham fisted when you want to do a different mission in a little bit.
My brother did 9/11.
My brother did 9/11. He paints beautiful pictures of the people he sent off to war. I'd love Ooh. And I don't mean this in like a I don't mean this again too political, but it's really funny how, like, everyone immediately said, like, yeah, George Bush is a great guy now, only because he started painting pictures. Like, nothing
he
that
paints.
He said.
He sat next to Ellen.
He sat next to Ellen.
Guys, Ellen likes him.
Yeah, if like, the world's meanest lesbian of all time can like him, then I should like him, too.
That wasn't me, guys. It was Dick Cheney. I was just painting.
That was just my evil brother, Jorge. Shadow George, police
there was
officer.
This really funny I forget if it was a video or just an article, but it was from The Onion, where it was like George Bush takes up painting portraits of the Iraqi kids who haunt him.
Oh,
he
man
must have nightmares.
Do you remember
how many donuts? 12.
5 of 12. I'm good at this. We might actually get like really deep into this game by the end of this stream. I'm pretty fast. Chocolatey goodness.
You're already like 4 levels in. Like, you've unlocked a lot of new zones. I don't think I get this far when I had the game.
I'm pretty good at Tony Hawk. I you may not know me, but this is before I knew Kev. I did a 24-hour Tony Hawk stream where I played through all the Tony Hawk games and like you would have loved that shit if we knew each other or had the avenue to network.
Yeah, if it ever happens again.
Next time I do a big charity stream. Yeah, so I beat this game. I beat like all the original ones because those aren't too hard to really beat.
Yeah, you fly through those.
It's all about replaying those. That's like the real deal with those. But when I beat this and I beat the Tony Hawk's Underground 2, that game is so weird purely because it really is just Bam Margera's like bizarre adventure.
They had a star on their hands. They're like, we gotta milk this thing.
Well, I mean, everyone sure did love Viva La Bam. Because that show was great. Because back in 2004, the one thing you wanted to do was disrespect your parents. And that show was like, man, Bam's a skateboarder. Skateboarding's cool. And man, he doesn't let his dad get away with anything. I wonder how much Tom and Jerry shit kids that watched that show did to their dad. Just because they saw Bam do it to his Uncle Phil.
Yeah, that was probably a rough time to be a dad.
Yeah.
Yeah, your son pranking your ass.
That's the one time.
Filming it.
That's probably why so many people hated MTV back then. Like I said, like, MTV's a bad influence on kids. Well,
my son keeps digging a hole in the lawn and letting me fall into it with the mower. This damn MTV.
A case in every town in America. Every day. Every week.
There I we bet go. Kids just got hit a lot more when they were influenced.
Yeah, like,
by Viva La Bam. I think they would try that shit once with their dad, and then they get a swift fucking slap and go, oh, shit.
Oh, like someone, shit.
Like, maybe like a parent who would never even think of doing that until they were like, you know, they got triggered, like, what was his name, Vito?
Yeah.
Yeah, they got, or yeah, they're like, oh, that shit happens and it's over.
Their influential son comes in and punches him in the face and slaps him with a toilet plunger while a camcorder's filming it in the corner. That kid's getting a backhand, man. There ain't no way he's getting away with it. They ain't getting paid millions like the Margeras.
Now that you got that down.
Well, you need 2 skateboards to do that trick.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I just
it's called the
that.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, right. I
see
get
why.
It.
Yeah. All right, gotta get special and then do a yeah right through the cones. All right, when do I gotta let go? Don Vito's not innocent. He knows what he
skitching.
Did.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit, this is weird.
All that Vito stuff got cut from like the last Jackass
down,
movie.
Okay.
And I was so pissed because I was always like
why?
A bigger Brandon DiCamillo fan than like. Necessarily like a Bam Margera fan, and all the stuff that DiCamillo had filmed for the last Jackass movie was with Don Vito, so that by proxy got all his stuff cut too.
I never use manuals of special tricks because it feels so weird to have to
12
do quarter...
years.
Thank you, Drum Surfer. It feels so weird doing quarter circle forward stuff for like doing a manual. It's always just been down up. Oh, combo Zenic down up.
Yeah, is it not in this game?
No. That's why the special trick I have to do like some like quarter circle forward stuff. And I just want that extra trick spot.
Do you guys think they're gonna make any more Tony Hawk games like after the popularity of the 1 and 2 remake? Like not just remakes, but like new ones?
Bring that board back that you had to stand on.
Oh yeah.
I always remember Ride. That one Egg of 64 skit where it's like it was Derek. He said like if a parent comes in and asks for Tony Hawk's Ride, tell them that is a bad game. Do not get that.
Man, I watched people play that at some E3 for like an hour. I just sat in front of the Tony Hawk Ride booth and watched people
that must have been great. I got that for Christmas. It sucked.
Adults got up on that thing with no balance and just fell flat on their asses over and over again.
Whenever I tried playing that game, I would just spaz out of the board. Because I didn't skateboard. So I was just like, all right, it's time to do a trick. So I just step on both sides of the board and just tap dance on it, trying to get points.
Make him get points, yeah.
So Grim Jim in the chat actually says Activision owned the license, so now Microsoft can milk it now.
Ooh. Oh, that might actually work out.
Maybe there's a silver lining to this whole thing. I don't know.
They'll keep going.
They keep going with
everything.
They really did get Activision for pennies on the dollar, because why wouldn't they? That shit was so bad.
That's crazy. That was breaking news today. I saw that today, right?
Yeah.
Like, how could they? Like, that is, like, that's an easy pickup. There's so many IPs you could use. Where's this car?
I didn't seem to give two shits about many of those Activision properties, so I was kind of
What's so funny about it is that they included Candy Crush in the graphics, so Activision couldn't have been doing well.
That's just for their investors. They want their stock to go up.
It's like Activision Blizzard, so it was Overwatch and
Overwatch died immediately. Like when Overwatch first came out and it was the demo, the free to play demo that everyone could get into, I thought that shit was so tight.
I still know a surprising amount of people who do actively still play it. Did they ever come out with a sequel? Because I know that for years there were Overwatch 2 is coming, and then
just core. Core Overwatch with different seasons is how they operate all these games now.
Man, I don't know. I kind of tune out when it comes to
They just announced that a new character is pansexual now. Every 3 months.
That's how they breathe new life into that game.
What's so funny is you can say that's an uncharitable way to put it. It's no, they actually do that though. That's happened multiple times.
Shit goes down on inside baseball shit, I guess you could say, happens, and they're
Trobjorn is plural.
Yeah, right.
Whenever a head honcho commits a crime, they just release media to smooth everything over.
I'm gonna be right back. I used the head real quick.
I just imagining if that kind of shit happened in Nintendo. And they're just fucking Shulk is pansexual. Yeah.
Hello, gay Bowser. No more bye-bye. Bowser,
That wasn't a mispronunciation. No, he actually, Mario was addressing him properly.
Yeah, you heard, Doug Bowser gets the new CEO guy that replaced Reggie. He gets up in a press conference and he's like, "You thought we said goodbye, but now say hello to Gay Bowser."
The
character.
Exactly. He's like, not that there's anything wrong with that, but
it is so confusing that they have the same last name. I want Reggie back.
Yeah, I miss Reggie.
Bring Reggie back.
For real. What he left and then he joined GameStop or something at the worst possible time. And then I think left almost immediately.
He did that just to cash in and cash out on that stock when the stock market, everyone spent their
stimulus. I didn't spend...
That was Reggie, dude.
I was the one person that made money from Dogecoin because I invested $10 in it as a joke. I was like, oh man, this stuff's less than a cent. This is stupid. And then it happened and I made money from it.
You're an entrepreneur, man.
Yeah, you just invested in stuff that's stupid. It's like that episode of King of the Hill where Peggy and Khan's wife are trying to play the stock market. So they just invest in what Bill thinks is where every business Bill goes to.
I've got one thing to say, and it's been said since the days of the Intrepids, fortune favors the brave.
Fortune favors the bold. Yeah.
Is that that fucking
that's Jeb. Jeb.
Oh,
there's a reference.
That's really
that crypto That Crypto.com commercial with Matt Damon?
Dude, I remember the first time I saw that. I think I was like before Dune. And I didn't know it was going to happen. And I just like cut my hands and I yelled like, boo! And then the whole,
oh
like,
my God.
Like, and the whole theater did start booing it too. And it was just like,
have you seen this, sir?
You know,
no. Do I have to look at it?
Well, in theaters, it's probably online too, but in theaters, they started showing like before the movie trailers, this fucking crypto.com commercial starring Matt fucking Damon. And I knew halfway through, because there's a shot of these astronauts, and one of them has the name tag that says Satoshi. So right when that comes up, I start going like, what the fuck, dude? This is like some Bitcoin shit. Like, there's no way. And he gives this like really fucking mundane speech about taking a risk with investment.
And well, he proceeds it by like talking about like the greatest achievements of mankind, like taking
discovering
flight,
new
going
countries.
To space. Yeah, and then it's just like, and crypto.
Christianity conquering the world.
Right, yeah.
The crucifixion, and then it just flashes through moments of history, shows the crucifixion of Christ, discovery of electricity, and Matt Damon's like, do you want to take risks? And it just shows like Iwo Jima and all that stuff. Invest in Dogecoin today.
Serb, you're not far off.
It's like that. But fortune favors the brave.
Yeah.
Like, fuck you, Matt.
It's the same shit they're pulling with the fucking, like, Bored Ape stuff. Well, everybody hates us, so we must be doing something good. And it's just like, I mean,
they aren't
really.
But like the thing
simple.
Is with that is that NFT hatred has become like Kony 2012, where it's like, I wouldn't say it's overblown. It's happened before with art trading all the time. This is not new. But like people are like, oh my god, like the tree, like people like have people get madder at someone for like creating an NFT than they would for discovering that he did sex crimes.
Well, I think like it's like you mentioned art trading, but it's like the thing about that is art connects with people on an emotional level. Like you see something, you're not just buying it just because it's
yes,
a piece
yeah,
of art.
Yeah.
You like it, you whatever, but it's like this NFT. It's like you're just
it's
buying
money laundering.
It it's a fucking monkey with a cigarette. That's why.
Well, that makes it cooler.
Oh, you're in Monkey Clan. I'm a lazy lion boy.
Are you more of a lazy? Like,
I'm a funky monkey. 2978. Is this how
just
I get
learning about all this shit? Is what's insane, but also like fun. Just shitting on this for the last 2 months has been a wild ride. But we're reaching the end.
When it the thing is, I don't hear enough horror stories besides rug pull. So I was just like, wait, are these people actually making money and just laughing at us? Like we're like being all smug to them. And then they're actually making mad bank, and we're just like being like, all right, clicks. And people are like, no, there isn't a massive amount of crossover between them and the r/poverty subreddit. They're like, oh, okay.
You know, one of my favorite things now, though, is when, because we're so used to like companies like teasing an announcement for like an NFT, like, you know, Konami put out those Castlevania NFTs and everything.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you saw on Twitter like just a few hours ago. You know, like Viz Media, like they publish like, you know, Shonen Jump and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
They put out some tweet today. Yeah. We're like, we have an exciting announcement tomorrow. We have a great new way to show off that you can love how you can love. Let me find it.
How you can love your favorite manga. And it really was looking like it was going to be NFTs, but it wasn't. But that's
exactly like that's what it was.
They said, yeah, it's a picture of Luffy from One Piece, and it says, soon you'll be able to show your Shonen Jump love in a whole new way. Exciting announcement tomorrow. And all the replies were just, this better fucking not be an NFT thing, or I'm going to cancel my subscription. And 3 hours later, they replied to their own tweet, and they said, it's not NFTs, with a smiley emoji.
So that's the thing I see now where, like, companies or individuals will walk back the NFT announcements. Like, guys,
it is the worst possible press.
Right? I saw just the other day a voice actor, Troy Baker, was like launching some NFT thing, and his fan base just came back hard against him. But I think he's still sticking to it. He's defending it. But I've seen other people like walk it back. Like, all right, we're not doing it anymore. Fuck, sorry.
The quickest turnaround I've seen was Rob McElhenney from Always Sunny.
Uh-huh.
Did you see that one?
No.
He had it up for, I believe, a total of 28 minutes. He changed his avatar to one of those like bored apes, and he tweeted like he's like, I'm coming aboard the Bored Ape Yacht Club, yada yada yada, and everybody was just like replying like, man, this sucks. And 28 minutes later, he changed his profile picture back to a picture of him and deleted the tweet and never talked about it again.
Apparently, you could get into like secret like parties of that. Like, apparently, there's like a point to it. I don't know. Like, I'm saying there's a point to it with a question mark.
Yeah. What kind of party is that? And no thanks.
It's like your least favorite guy to get, like, stuck in a conversation with, like a high school, alumni party.
Like, let them party together so we don't have to talk to them.
Yeah.
I've been in those conversations before at parties.
But, sir,
with finance pages.
That fucking...
Like, you imagine if you just, like, brought up the best idea is just imagine these guys are using this to get into parties with just themselves so the rest of the world doesn't have to fucking hear or talk to them.
It would be great, because then I wouldn't have to see everyone get mad
at
them.
These parties suck.
Yeah, there's no apets. Hey, where's the apets?
Yeah. It's just gotta be a low ratio is what I'm saying. I mean,
yeah,
a
low ratio.
Shitty party. Yeah.
And, like, I mean...
I don't have the air for this. Fuck.
The family of like Stan Lee, weren't they using his Twitter?
Oh, that is that is worth getting mad at. Like that
sucks. I think
that was the most fury I saw was Stan Lee's old Twitter account.
Well, there should have been fury for what's been doing that account for like ages now. I'm glad it's happening now, but they've been like they puppeted that account. They did a Weekend at Bernie's type thing with that account like for ages. And
but the funny thing was, like, the announcement was, like, we're starting off our Marvel NFTs with our Indian superhero, Chakra, the Invincible.
Oh, yeah, that's like, awesome.
And we were like, did this guy exist before, or did you just, like, create a POC superhero to sell fucking NFTs with a dead man's Twitter account?
It's wrong on so many levels.
Exactly. I mean, you have to marvel at it, and some, you know, no pun intended, but you have to fucking, like, marvel at that, how some people could be so fucking off, you know, and then just completely blow it in the public eye.
I do love the name Kingo for,
Kingo, yeah.
And he just fucking dies in the first movie. Sorry!
Oh, shit, Kingo dies? Damn it!
But that's like that's the greatest superhero name ever.
Sorry, spoiler.
Sorry, Kevin Grumbus dies in the movie.
All the names in that movie are like, Dr. Seuss characters. Like, not even like.
Yes!
Sprite
Ublek.
Like Pringle.
I just walked. I've only walked in on parts of that film as it's been on, like, Disney Plus or whatever at my house. And I had no idea it set up for like a sequel. They want to Internals too.
That's how little we care for it. You mispronounce it immediately.
Yeah. Well, that was a fun joke. I think Rocco fit that into the live show at some point when referring to that film instead of Externals or whatever. What is it called?
Eternals. Yeah.
Eternals. Yeah. Internals. It's about right.
Oh, whenever, you know what's funny though, like I know like you guys have a reputation for like with your sketches and videos and everything have like predictions for the future that end up coming true.
Yeah.
Cuz I remember when I saw your live show in Chicago and Rocco did his Stan Lee character when he was like doing a séance and like he took on the soul of Stan Lee for that sketch. And then straight up a week later was when the Stan Lee Twitter account was tweeting about this NFT thing. And I think I actually tweeted that
relevant,
Rocco. I'm like, you done it again.
Here we go. We got knockdown on the bottles.
Some stuff some stuff you write is evergreen. You know, we got lucky with a couple of those in the live act. Although sometimes it was fun to change shit around backstage, like before the show. Like, oh my god, we would read about some shit that just happened. Like the night that the drummer Neil Peart died. I believe we were in the green room reading the news, and then Rocco decided, like, during the seance, Neil Peart is showing up.
That's great.
You know, it's a little of each. I think we broke the news to several people in that audience. Oh, my ankle.
That's always the best way to find out. I remember finding out that Gary Coleman died because I saw, like, someone at an open mic do a joke about him dying. Like oh, the tiniest casket, I guess it was like Gary Coleman bought it, and I'm like, I had to Google on my phone, I'm like, what the fuck, Gary Coleman died?
Is that real?
Yeah.
Twitter is always how I find out someone died now.
When Bob Saget died, I changed my account to be TMZ, and I copied and pasted the obituary for that, but I put a picture of Danny DeVito. And I changed the URL for that to be Danny DeVito, and I got so many people, but I didn't want to get suspended.
I saw that. I was like, I remember for like a split second you had me, because like you had your avatar changed to the TMZ.
I full sent that bit. That was...
Like, how many people did you, like,
commitment.
Piss off?
Like, I was at, like, 600 likes for a bit there, and then I deleted it, because I didn't want to lose my account.
The mods woke up.
Yeah, I wanted to get that in and out before the mods went away, and I was like, alerta, alerta. Yeah.
Well, that was perfect.
What was so good about it is that Justin Wang retweeted it, and what's so cool about him is that he's always has a tendency to be in on the joke. Where are you from?
I came all the way down from New Jersey. Dude, Justin Wang is one of those guys who just, like, everybody just... in any circle just seems to know him or know of him. It's crazy.
I love his shit, man. I think that's your next K-Town get, sir.
He was actually our first.
Oh, you got him. Dude, I'm so happy to be traveling in such good company.
Yeah, I remember, like...
We got him, we got Matt Watson.
We had him on our show maybe, like, 3 or 4 years ago because, like, obviously he was, like... His channel was way smaller at the time, but I remember he was, I think he started off filming videos for Asterios Kokonos.
Oh, wow. So he runs in that circle, too.
Yeah, yeah, because there was this
video. Wang
runs
everywhere. That's what's cool about him, honestly.
Asterios Kokonos, this is, like, from, like, 2016 or 2017, where, when, like, the r/the Donald still existed.
Oh, my God.
And they would pick fights with Asterios a lot for whatever fucking reason. And, you know, they would always be like, oh, show up in person, I'll box you, I'll fight you. You know, that's kind of, like, a thing people do for some reason.
They do that now a lot, actually.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah. Sure, certain someone
Logan
seems
Paul
to be doing
money.
That a lot right now. But, anyway, So Asterios is like, yeah, I'll fucking fight you. And he shows up and, like, they meet at this, like, MMA gym in New York at, like, 2 a.m. And, like, they just, like, beat the shit out of each other in this, like, ring with, like... But, like, I guess, like, that was Justin Wang was the one filming it. And I think that he started his YouTube channel after that or right around that time. I could be wrong, but it was one of those things where, yeah, you know, he was kind of working with, you know, Asterios and then started to do his own thing.
What was my question is about Justin Wang was, like, what was, like, the video that put him on the map? Because, like, every single one of his things are, like, very fun interest stories. But, like, what was the first time that he did it that it worked? Because there always is the one video, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to look up his channel right now and see what's his most popular upload. I mean, like, I think
it's
got to
be the most popular.
The first one
did
I ever saw from him was the
Brian
Peppers video.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's it, yeah. Same. That's what I saw first. I was like, what is this retrospective on Brian Peppers? And then I saw he had
a whole
series.
Yeah, do you remember that? YTMND?
Yeah.
I was so into YTMND. Like, every day, like, after, like, sophomore year of high school, I would come home. I would spend hours on YTMND, like, just making up the dumbest shit. Because, like, that was when I think, like, back when memes were called, like, fads. Or, like, oh, the Brian Peppers fad.
That was... Not to be, like, true. And suck off Garrett here, but, like, that was me with Mega 64. When I would play, like, it was, like, it was a WWE game where you create your own wrestler for the story mode, and I made my wrestler be Magic City Man.
Was that one of that was one of Rocco's characters, if I remember
Sean.
Correctly?
And, Sean, it was, yeah. Sean was him, and I also made King with a K. Oh, I would always G King with a K is the name, please. FBI. Oh, yeah. What does that spell? Fire beats ice.
It's weird. It is weird, like, dumb shit we filmed turned into, in certain groups of friends, like, a memeable fucking quotable thing. That's fucking so bizarre.
When I was, like, DMing you earlier, I was like, oh, man, I look up to you. I look up to all your content. It was a big part of my, does it ever, like, when you're at the level that you are, does it ever, stop being surprising or, just sort of, like, stop surprising you?
No, when I hear stuff like this, it's always, like, a wake-up call. Because I guess, like, you throw it out, like, you know.
Oh, yeah, because I watched you in high school.
Yeah. So, like, it's always a surprise to me because, like, I don't spend, or I try not to spend any time really thinking about that. I still just feel like some dude who's making shit with my friends. So the fact that there is an audience out there, I think I tend to, like, forget about it. And move on to the next thing, and then when I hear someone has seen this thing or like referenced this thing, or I get feedback from you on that, I'm like, oh shit, that is
because okay.
It's always new and it's always like appreciative.
Oops, no, I'm not ending these runs. No, fuck.
Yeah, I feel like that's like the healthiest way to approach it.
It really is. You have like a. Probably better than even I. That probably definitely better than how I handle it, even at my low level. Like just like on to the next one, not getting wrapped up in any accolades. Yeah. That's the right way to do it. That's how you like stay at that level. I think, like not going completely insane.
I've tried to totally like keep my nose to the grindstone and be absorbed into like what's the current thing I'm working on. And then after a project is wrapped or done, like, I forget about it, which is, it's funny, like, when you quoted those King with a K lines.
Yeah, that was
like,
just something
I about...
filmed at the pool.
Yeah, I haven't thought about that video, which was, I think, probably, like,
that's an oldie.
Something filmed for IGN or something. Like, I don't remember even who originally, but I was so devoted to that when we were making it, and then once it was out, it's, like, out of my mind. And I don't think
He's
about
dead.
It being used all these years or, like, it coming back around. And it's, like, it's wild. It's wild that the longevity of Mega 64 has gotten to the point to where, like, yeah, we have kind of, for the first time in the last couple of years, I will say, there's this feeling of, like, we're the grandfathers of internet video. We're the...
Because now you're starting to see people that had your videos as inspo, I would say.
Yeah, totally.
And now they're starting to come to the forefront. And now you're starting to see the fruits of your labor.
Totally. We'll meet people who tell us that, like, we inspired them with this thing that we made 15 years ago. And it's like...
And it'll be a throwaway
video.
Shit.
It has been a long time. That's crazy that we're still here. We're still doing this. Because I don't think that many groups can say that. Here are the rules. I don't know how many there are that have been consistently, you know, putting content out there as many years as Mega 64 has. So we've got this like grandfathered in kind of like people give us this respect, which is like, wow, this feels nice. I don't know. Not used to this, but it's cool to hear. It's always cool to hear.
There we go.
Yeah, I mean like. I'm fucking 31 years old, and I'm thinking about it now. I think I've been watching your guys' videos for more than half of my life. How much I'm realizing now that's
crazy.
Insane.
Yeah. I talked to so many people over our tour when we would have the meet and greets and just hang out after the show. And hearing stuff like that, Kevin, like how many years and how like, specifically, like, yeah, over half of people's lives, like a lot of people in their 30s who started watching when they were, like, in middle school.
Uh-huh.
I just think about some of the shit we said inappropriately back in the fucking early days.
Oh, dude, I wouldn't worry about that.
I think about how are you scared people are gonna find out you're racist?
How did I influence 13-year-olds? Oh no, they've already figured that out by now. So
yeah, we've heard the chicken dance.
But
oh,
but people in middle school watching me in my early 20s spout non-information on a podcast around a campfire with three of my other friends. It's just funny to see, like, someone in their, you know, 30s with a kid at home going, "Hey, thanks, man."
Dude,
really,
yeah,
like...
speaking of
oh, yeah, a lot of your friends, a lot of your fans either have kids, like, on the older spectrum, they either have kids or, like, me, where I'm just, like, starting out making something.
Final round. I'm with you.
Like
no
our,
kids,
you know,
and
Eric,
I feel like
our
I'm
one,
just
our
making
one friend,
something.
KT Shane, who was supposed to come to the Chicago show but couldn't because his wife was giving birth, he did tell me that he got to see you guys in Texas when you guys came down there.
That's right. I think we talked to them post, like, childbirth, like the baby was brand new.
I was just happy to see the whole thing come full circle.
We talked to a couple people that said that they were definitely, like, shown by an older brother, and then they're showing their kids now, and I'm
Man.
Just like, well, be careful what you show them, I guess. Todd and Aaron isn't for everyone, but
yeah.
8 or 5 minutes, the kids like those ones.
Back when I was before I thought, like, I could ever, like, create anything and, like, end up meeting people like you, I would, like, say to myself, like, I think I could probably be friends with Rocco or Garrett, but Derek would be so mean to me.
You know,
he always gets that.
He's a chill guy. I mean, like,
he gets that a lot.
People will ask that during Q&A. Yeah, we go do an anime expo or something, and that's always, like, during a Q&A. Like, this is someone alluding to that, and then he makes it even worse because he just lays the awkwardness on.
I think he knows how to perform.
he's a gentle boy. We all are. We're hardly boys anymore, though. That's what's weird.
Medium scary.
15 years.
I would say it's medium level scary.
Yeah. Well, I'm like the canary in the coal mine. If I can keep trucking, you guys don't have anything to worry about.
No, we gotta pick our deck. We gotta pick our deck company now.
Oh shit, bro! You did so good in the Boom Boom Huck Jam that you got sponsored.
Yes, sir.
Right.
I might actually be able to beat this on stream. I actually might.
Zero.
Oh man, what do you guys want?
Jamie Thomas in this game?
No, I don't think so. That's four. He was the first guy I ever did a mission 4-4 at the college level. Oh, who do we do? Do you want to join up with Bam?
Bam over at Element, or I would say Zero is my vote.
I've never done Zero. One?
Yeah, I'm going to step away real quick. I'll be right back.
I'm going to go Zero, because I've never done them yet. It does not affect the story. In modern video games, though, this would affect the story. It would be like those Telltale games, where it would just be like, Bam will definitely remember this.
this starts the dialogue tree down the dark path of Zero.
Yeah, the Renegade Path. Oh, San Diego.
Oh,
I've never
look,
liked
you're going
San
to San Diego.
Diego. Oh, shit.
So maybe this is the Balboa Park level I was thinking of, dude.
Okay, wait. We got to cruise for a bit.
This is my hometown. This is where... See, like, I don't know about Kevin, but did you skate growing up?
I skated a little in college. I never did a kickflip, but I could ollie while moving, which is better than most people could say.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Ollie while moving, it's up there.
I could do Casper into, like, a very slow roll.
I was dubbed someone who did neat ollies by a couple of my friends because they were just very tiny. I would ollie off the curb, but really it was just riding off the curb. But then, I don't know. I can fuck around a bit now and then.
What's your favorite decks? Mine will be very easy to guess.
JK. Well, right now it was always Alien Workshop because I'm such a '90s kid. But and then I would ride Toy Machine. I definitely had a thing for We're gonna have you later. Element for a while there. I had a BAM deck.
Okay. Chat, I'm gonna have you guys guess what decks I would get. You guys would probably be able to get it.
I'm thinking you're a hookups kind of dude.
He beat you guys to it.
I'm just saying, you know, I'm looking at your social media avatars, looking at your Twitch icon. Just something screaming.
Strictly hookups. I have the Girl for Gun one, and I got the Battle School Girl one. That's the one I have.
See, if I had a dope ass deck like that, I would never want to skate it. Like, it took me.
I got scared when it started to actually scratch up. I was like, "This is awesome art." By the way, like, I was watching some videos where, for some reason, you'd be shirtless. Do you have a Rei Ayanami tattoo, or is that just something blue?
Yeah, well, that's 100% confirmed here. You heard it first on K-Town. I have a gigantic Ayanami Rei tattoo on the entire side of my body.
That's so sick.
I would say chest, but it's not just chest. It's we're going hip to
rib cage.
We're going hip to nip. Yeah,
that's beautiful.
It's the whole side.
I like how he calls K Town. It is K Zone, but just keep calling us K Town because that's awesome.
Have I done that twice now? That's completely
don't apologize. That's awesome. It's awesome.
What is K Town?
Remember off moment.
That's Koreatown.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I dated a girl up there.
There you go. Oh, yeah, someone linked when I announced you were going on. It's like, yeah, someone, like, Seinfeld the Hedgehog linked a video that said, Garrett's sexual partners.
Oh, that's the lasagna cat thing?
I first saw that video, that was, like, such a funny Easter egg to me.
35.
So you were you actually just confused? 35. So you were like just saying your name and age?
Yeah, I was at work when I was still working at the construction company, and I had seen like, Lasagna Cat's doing this interactive 1-800 number thing, but I didn't read anything. I just dialed before I had finished like looking into it.
Oh, I also work for a construction company, by the way.
Then so we have that in common. Yes. Do you prefer high visibility yellow or orange?
High visibility yellow. I was an inspector, so
I was I went with a lot of orange, technician status.
I would be an inspector, and all of the guys hated me because I would try to make them actually do their job.
You gotta watch out for those inspectors, Kevin.
Yes. Oh boy.
They come around. Especially an OSHA clipboard.
Especially Inspector Gadget. Who's the Inspector Gadget actor that killed somebody?
Matthew Broderick killed somebody?
Yeah, he killed two people in a car crash in Ireland.
Bad day for Broderick heads.
Yeah, I forget the exact
time. If you guys didn't know.
That happens. That happens, right? Halle Berry, it happened to her, right?
I don't know. I mean, that's news to me.
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta start the manual.
Caitlyn Jenner, I think that happened to Caitlyn Jenner.
Yeah, that did happen.
Oh, speaking of going way back, that Starving Games, not Starving Games, the Hungover Games, that bad parody movie, they had Caitlyn Jenner back when Caitlyn Jenner was Bruce as an actor in it, playing Skip, like their Skip Bayless parody, which is just
this is way back 08 or something. Then
I don't know. I think it was like right before the transition happened.
Oh, Hollywood, always relevant.
I missed the flip. Oh, I did a varial here. Flip.
So this area in Balboa Park is like, it's a big operatic theater. We filmed a bunch of skits here for Mega 64 because there's always public around this big orchestra amphitheater and this horse statue and all this shit's all here.
I bet someone could definitely probably go right here. None of the curbs are actually skatable. Like, no. It doesn't take place in a dystopia where everything is skatable.
But they nailed it. See how it's like a hacienda, or it's kind of like Spanish, you know, like themed? And the archways are all like that. You got the palm trees.
Oh, yeah.
This is it. This is how it is.
Well, that's a window into Mega 64. Air
out
the
pond right there. The pond behind you guys, that's where Derek floated a little baby doll. I forget which video it was.
That could be anything. Baby doll video, I think of,
I'm trying to think. There was a doll that we threw in a stroller down some stairs and it pissed off some lady. That was here. What video was that for?
VG Fact. No. That's different. Garrett had a gun for that.
There's been a lot of doll abuse. It's always funny, you know, I think we got that from Jackass, where they leave the baby doll strapped into the car seat on top of the SUV and drive away. Wasn't that in the first Jackass movie? Wow. Or maybe just the show. Daddy's Day Out or something. We're definitely influenced by that one.
There we go. Got third grab photo. Is that it?
Crazy. 1 foot tail grab over the atrium gap.
Come on, over the atrium gap.
Oh, hey, shout out Zwick in the chat. What's up, man?
Zwick. Hey, Zwick.
I like introducing new people. Oh, wait, whoa. I gotta get in the magazine ad. I gotta do a spine transfer over this. Okay. Alright, here we go. We're gonna become famous. Alright, so one time in college, there was this kid that stole cigarettes from a Russian exchange student. And they had, a big fight. And, he was, sitting in his bed while the Russian exchange student was, confronting him. And the Russian exchange student said, "I'll make you famous, bitch, all day!" And he just punches him in the face. In front of, 30 people.
Is that a quote from a movie that he said?
No!
Isn't that...
No!
Hey, check out the ad for the Idaho kid. I would love if your Russian friend just watched a lot of American TV and he's like, "Yes, quote from Doc Hollywood in movie, I will say this."
You feeling lucky, punk? Well, yeah.
The best part about that was he wasn't my friend. He was this weird, when I say Russian exchange student, he wasn't my age. He was 36, and he ended up getting kicked out for dealing drugs on campus. But
got one of those exchange students.
So
yeah.
One day we're all about to go out in the town. And I was what are you about to go out and do? He's like, "Oh, I'm about to go schnobbing." And I was just we were on the lunch line. I was like, "What's schnobbing?" He turns to the kid behind him. He's like, "This kid, he doesn't know what schnobbing is." And I was like, as if it's "Oh, get a load of this virgin." And I was like, "Dude, what's schnobbing?" He's like, "Dude, I genuinely don't know." And the person that he was turning to was he was a D3 football player, a stereotypical Chad. And he's just like, "Dude, I'm gonna level with you. I have no idea what this guy's fucking talking about." And he's like, "Listen,
yeah,
I'm not.
It a bit?
I don't know what schnobbing is. It is one of the biggest mysteries of my life."
What did this guy deal cocaine?
Yeah, I think so. He always
it
wore Ed Hardy
like
shirts, bedazzled Ed Hardy shirts.
Okay, so I just looked.
I can picture him.
And the first result on Urban Dictionary is an action in which a female masturbates with a doorknob.
Whoa!
This guy's crazy.
This guy was into schnobbing? We stopped to
get some grub, and while we I can't find anything else saying otherwise, so.
This guy was watching a girl, go reverse cowgirl on a bunch of doors. But hey, the guy's last name was Nomov. Naumov. And we all just called him that.
Well, are we doxing your friend, in quotes, cocaine dealer? Yeah.
There's a lot of different names that were like that.
Doxing the plug.
Buddy, come over. We're going to go schnobbing.
We're going to go schnobbing.
Yeah, I'm good.
He was so cool. Yeah.
Still gotta find out. It's probably either a sex act or some kind of drug. That's most.
One time I asked him what he was up to when he was going out of the town, and he's like, "Oh, you don't want to know." And he made the baby Grinch from the live action Grinch movies, the face it makes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He made that face after that. The baby Grinch face.
Yeah, he probably right. I don't want to know.
I don't want to know what that guy was up to. But you know what?
He's
that guy fucks.
Shit.
The thing is though, is that like you can't deny that that guy fucks. I mean, he definitely fucks. But
oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to be involved in whatever fucking that guy's doing? Probably not.
You could be involved in some schnobbing as well.
Oh yeah, it's that could be bad.
That's just the foreplay. A little schnob before.
Schnob on my knob.
Oh, he's a schnob. Yeah, yeah, makes sense.
Maybe that was just his way of saying he was getting head.
I mean, maybe.
But who knows?
So you're doing graffiti wall plants?
Yes, yes, yes. Graffiti is one of the most degenerate things ever.
Physics in this game, this is not realistic.
Yeah, it would take much shorter than one frame.
Oh, Swick in the chat says, if you're a foreign exchange student, you're going to fuck. I feel like that's an unwritten rule. And I think he's right.
Well, there was
he's absolutely right.
There was this one foreign exchange student from, Afghanistan that we had in my high school. And the popular kids got a hold of him, and they corrupted him to the point where he would walk up to random girls and say, like, oh, you're not as hot as the girls from my country. You'd be a 3. And they'd be like, yo!
He gaslighted them.
They decided to be like, yo, let's turn this, like, regular Arab kid into, like, let's make him evil. It's like, yo, let's make this Egyptian kid evil.
Yeah.
Turn him into the enemy from like Karate Kid or something. This is
let's make him like Johnny,
right off,
Johnny Cobra.
Right off the screen. Yeah.
Ooh. Where's the last one? That's what's annoying about this game. It's like okay, you gotta do like 5 different places, but you don't know where to go. And I mean, like they can't guide your hand to make you do DSP shit where it's like, oh, you have to know where this is. Blah blah blah. But
it's
I don't know where it is.
Hard.
It was. And the people would yell, yo, skater.
Good.
I saw somebody in the chat earlier mention the skate games. Have you guys ever played those?
Yes, and you can break those so beautifully.
Are they better or worse than Tony Hawk, or they're kind of like
different,
on the same level?
Different genre, I would call it. It's a different discipline. This is arcade. Those are simulation. Like, when you do, like, a nice line in those games, it's like a nice line. You'd say, like, for, like, Birdhouse, Trick of the Year! And it's, like, something within the realm of reality.
Okay, so you wouldn't be
it's not like acrobatic,
like
on the
this.
Top of the fucking roof,
pulling out a pizza
you're
or
not
sparklers,
a telephone pole.
Yeah, Darth, you're telling me Darth
Maul's
not
wall planting.
Unlockable.
Yeah, Darth Maul isn't real.
At least to me.
So, I played those skate games, but then I also play a game called Skater XL, which is like
that's interesting.
Even
I've never
more. It's like even more in the realm of a simulator where like each analog stick is a foot. So like depending on how you flick the left and the right analog stick, you can just do, you know, way realistic real world style like runs and tricks. It's fun.
My friend Pat plays that a lot. Oh, no, I didn't mean to do McTwist. Fuck that.
Were you trying to make twist here? You don't have enough room.
No. Yeah, exactly. No. Oh, I'm fucking this up. I'm beefing this. Come on. Oh, wait,
this
that's
is your
it.
Brain on drugs.
Yeah, kids.
They don't start out arcade games with the whole FBI warning about drug use anymore.
Well, that's Ronald Reagan for you. That's the Reagan administration.
What a weird thought. They're like, yo, we've got a,
this
we've
kid's
got a
playing
captive audience.
This kid's playing Daytona USA. This kid is liable to do drugs.
Yeah, he's here pumping quarters into this machine. Let's advertise to him. Let's fit this agenda into the rule book here. I mean, every fucking arcade game had that.
You still see him now today. Like not today in new games.
Yeah, winners don't do drugs, it was, right? Yeah.
But, like, then I'm thinking of, like, okay, then, like, the next era of popular arcade stuff, like, Bimani cabinets, like, stuff that come from Japan, like, didn't have any of those FBI warnings or...
Yeah.
The problem, that was purely an American thing. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
You don't see that nowadays because the only games that you see made by America are those Terminator Judgment Day machines. Yeah, or the Big Bass spinning wheel thing.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the arcade equivalent of gentrification.
They should mandatory put like a fucking long 5-minute FBI drug pre-roll at every golden tea machine in every bar across.
That would be perfect. That would prevent,
because it's only 60-year-olds playing those golden tea machines.
They have those arcade one-up stuff of like golden tea, and it's like, sorry man, like Gen X isn't playing golden tea, man. And like you were one generation too short. You were onto something with NBA Jam. But this,
my dad with his AOL email address is signing in to his golden tea account, you know, during the happy hour.
Yeah, exactly. It's Nickel Shot Night at Obamacare.
Watch a fucking pre-roll. Don't do drugs. I'm in a fucking bar.
This is where my plug is. That was
great. I was gonna say, don't a lot of the arcade machines in Japan have like the ashtray next to it? Like they're assuming you're gonna be like blasting cigs, you know?
What if they're the funny kind?
It's a performance enhancer.
Yeah, they're Joe Rogan said so.
Smoking is a PED in the golden tea community. They banned it for the high score, any percentage golden tea. You're not allowed to do it.
Yeah. No buts. No buts around here, guys.
No ands or ifs or buts. I got to really up my stats.
They don't still make Mortal Kombat machines, do they?
You're talking about, what's it, the arcade one-up? Because they do.
Well, I was going to say, I know they still make the new games, but...
Oh, no, that's old. That's...
Yeah.
So, like, yeah, 11 and...
Yeah.
Whatever is
could you imagine
Xbox
if they
or,
did?
Or PlayStation, but...
Could you imagine if the arcade was still live? How cool that'd be! Like these graphics.
Mortal Kombat 11.
Like at an arcade.
I mean, some of them still are. I mean, like, what is it? I think Midway is here in Chicago because I know when they had the most recent Mortal Kombat game came out, like they had this like disclaimer under it. It was like made in Chicago.
I remember that.
Yeah,
they're all
and
proud
like,
and shit.
A couple people from like the comedy and improv scene here too. Like, do
they
voice
Sub Zero? Oh, I was joking.
No, they do. Like I have like friends of friends know like the guy, like some of the character guys who like voice. I haven't played him in a while, but it's like.
Could you imagine if they did that for Boston at like Lunch Enjoyer? Patrick from Pod About List voice Sub Zero. He's like, ow!
I think that's not too far off, you know.
That would be great. Are you familiar with Pod About List, Garrett?
No.
My friend Pat.
Is it a podcast?
It's a podcast. I should probably show you a video. Me and Patrick would talk about how much we fucking love Mega 64. So I think I owe it to him to show this to you. A video of his I did.
Solid.
Yeah, I'm gonna do
Bro,
him a solid.
You got me.
I got
just like
you.
The FBI, I'm a captive audience here. You're going to advertise.
Oh, yeah. No, but this is funny. Oh, Garrett, that would be great.
Well, that's how I found out about...
Sir, me.
You, K-Town, K-Zone, K's
right,
Choice.
Here we go, and I'm going to show the chat this. This is one of my favorite videos that came out recently. No, not Ben Hughes. This. Here we go. This is one.
One that says
vote for Zorgon. Aww. Yeah, Lunch Enjoyer.
Zorgons like me aren't supposed to run for office. I was born aboard space vessel X-116 on the outer ring of the Nebulon Galaxy. Mother from Puerto Rico, father from Zorgon. I was born in a place where your galaxy code index determined your rank. I'm a warrior. A B-Wing pilot, and above all else, Zorgon. I murdered 1,400 Zoogs in the Battle of Jimmy. I've sired thousands of offspring with the Queen Bug. My name is Zorgon. A vote for me is a vote for blue lives everywhere.
Did not expect that twist at the
end.
That's
good.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of good stuff here.
That had a lot of good twists.
Let me see.
Oh, this is
no,
a
but that's
channel.
Great. That's
okay.
What I mean. Like,
oh, I've seen a couple of these. Okay.
Yeah, this is Patrick Remains.
Hi, my name's Dr. Fast, and I'm New York City's greatest superhero.
This is my friend Cam.
I run really fast. I fight crime, and that's pretty much all I need. I mean, I'm like the next generation of human. Because you know, you'll walk around, you'll see people, and you'll think, you know, this guy shouldn't be on the streets anymore. You know, I go in there if I need to do any like bathroom.
Who are your nemesises?
Would have to be Cardboard Man, Stinky Man, Dirty Man, Wrinkled Clothing Man. Of course they don't live in a house. Well, you want to be roommates with Stinky Man? I don't think so.
Do you have any friends?
Yeah, I have about 1,000 friends back on my home world. They're called the Gorgonian Army. They slay anyone I choose. So, pretty good friends. Do you guys have any, like, ex-girlfriends?
What would, why?
Oh, there's a criminal on that bus.
Bye.
Let him go.
Yeah, it's my lunch. Here, I've been working on breaking into the like friend scene. Mostly, I've gone on about 1,000 dates with women.
Can we talk to John? Can we see John?
Okay.
Hi, John.
Hello. I'm completely normal. I have to go now. Bye.
Hey, Dr. Fast.
Oh, didn't see you fellas there.
Oh, and the Caleb Genius one is great. Oh, the smoke weed one's also good too.
Math? Like constantly?
Wait, I've seen this dude.
You've seen Caleb? Yeah.
Math? Like constantly?
He's one of my boys.
Like pretty much every day, and I come up with all kinds of stuff, and I basically change like everything about math pretty much. Loving a number? Making love to a number?
Which number do you love the most?
8. There's a gas leak from my oven. People have been telling me to turn it off for a while.
Yeah, you should.
But I'm kind of addicted to popcorn. Albert Einstein was stupid. He didn't come up with anything original. You know who did?
I've seen this video as well.
This guy. You believe in evolution.
Turn on CNN.
Oh, what's going on CNN? Did who died? Did they hit the Pentagon again?
Oh. Breaking. Breaking news.
This one's good.
You know
that's
it.
That's funny. I've seen that video specifically.
We can smoke
that's
this?
Why I recognize that.
Yeah. You know it.
Come on. Wait. What is that guy doing here?
Oh, no. Dude,
pee real
cool.
Quick.
I brought him.
This
gonna
is good,
smoke
though.
With us. He's a cool guy.
He doesn't look like a cool guy.
He's cool, dude. He smokes weed like us.
Yeah. I smoke all the time. I'm really good at it.
Can you handle this?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm really good at it.
Okay.
Smoking weed with my best friends, it's my favorite thing to do.
Yeah, I like smoking weed, but I love doing it with you.
Smoky, 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 it's a puff puff past delight.
When friendship's paired with Mary Jane, everything will be alright.
Cause we love smoking weed, it's our favorite thing to do. We are the bestest friends, that much we know is true.
It's true, yeah.
Smokey, I'm sorry, I don't know.
That is not the song!
Where'd you even find this guy?
You stupid, sad, fat piece of shit.
I really thought you were cool, man.
I'm sorry.
I seriously did. You just go? Will you just
go?
Oh,
I'm gonna hit you in my car, bitch!
Bitch, yeah.
Fuck you!
Go!
You're spitting on a fleep.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. You're smoking weed with my best friends.
He's a favorite
thing.
Oh my god, he's doing push-up. Oh my.
You said you've seen one of those before?
I'm back.
The second one that you showed, I had definitely seen. Or the third one. I don't know. The one with the bald dude.
In Caleb's great, yeah. I feel like I gotta show. I've seen that.
I just naturally seen that video at some point, like in the last.
It went
like,
pretty viral.
Something. That's me, baby. Always picking up the latest viral hits.
That's you.
I try. Oh.
No, I had the pee.
Hey,
I had the world's worst. Go ahead.
I want to request a pee break as well. If you're taking one, I'm gonna do myself a favor and
exactly
real quick.
It only seems fair.
Is that
It will.
Does that sound good to you, Kev? Should I take one?
Go for it, man.
Both of you can take your pee breaks.
Oh, I already took one.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
I can tell.
You sound refreshed when you came back.
Yeah, it's you know, it just feels great.
I'm sitting here holding it like a simp. All right, I'm going to be back.
It's on CNN. Oh, I got acid drop off both the towers. The Twin Towers. So, Kev, how have you been doing, man?
Been good. I'm just really fucking busy lately. I've been writing for Hard Drive recently, which has been cool.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. You added that to your thing.
Yeah,
Do you have any articles?
I've had a good handful published. I should have one coming out like tomorrow or the day after again. But
what's the byline?
I don't want to spoil that one just yet. But I will say, like, one of the articles that I did do recently that like went viral even on 4chan was this article called the headline is just female video game character with undercut gonna piss a lot of people off for some reason. And the image is just like a girl with, you know, the undercut, like a kind of like a classic, you know, character design you see in video games. But for whatever reason, like, I mean, the comments on all the, you know, Instagram and Twitter and everything, because like I'll look at them to see like people who it's the like one of the most fun things about writing for them is like going through the comments and seeing the people who don't know that it's a joke. And like people were posting that on 4chan and stuff, and like it was like sparking this big debate and everything about like people who were like, well, actually it is a political move to have a girl with an undercut, and some people were like, who gives a fuck, it's just a haircut, and everyone's going back and forth.
It kind of proved your point.
Exactly, yeah. And I mean, I'm sure they were loving it, you know, they're getting the fucking clicks and engagement for it too.
Well, yeah,
so
that's what you want. Like, it's like, that's what the point of satire is. Good satire. Yeah, yeah. Everyone says, like, everyone's been like pushing to be like, no, everyone has to know what satire. It's like, no, it doesn't.
Well, I got a funny story about that. Like, so that was like the biggest one for me so far that seemed to piss people off for whatever fucking reason. But you might get a kick out of this. There was an article one of the other writers got pitched recently and got published. Let me find the exact headline here, because you're not gonna believe it when you find out that this is the thing that went like popular. Let me see.
If I still beat the slap after this, it's gonna be ridiculous.
So the headline image is just Phineas and Ferb, that cartoon.
Yeah.
It's a picture of them. Yeah, it says creators confirm Phineas and Ferb could have cured HIV whenever. And the creator of Phineas and Ferb responded to it. He's like this idea, like Jeff Swampy Marsh or whatever his name is. He was responding like, I did not say this. This is libel. Take this down. And like all these people are like, hey man, it's a joke website. You know, it's not real. And then he was like DMing them and like fucking like threatening legal action, wants to like do all the like, and it's just like, it's kind of funny. You think this stuff would happen more often, but then when it does, it's still kind of surprising, you know?
That's off. That's awesome.
So they were like, you know, there's been this back and forth with him, and he's like, you're on the team? Not really picking up the fact that it's like satire or that it's a joke.
That would be a great laugh, though.
Yeah, like somebody even linked him to another article where it was like, Luigi Amiibo curved to be able to hit G-spot or something like that. And was like, you're mad about the website that published this article. And then he was just like, well, I don't care. It's libelous and I didn't say it. And it's just like, what do you, like, have you
that
not heard
sucks.
Of The Onion? Like,
oh my God. So that bizarre. That's embarrassing on his part, man.
And he claims that kids are DMing him and asking him if it's true. So he's saying that, like, for that reason, it should not be.
I'm not to define
online.
The rest of the team. That's stupid. People
will lie about shit like that. Like, kids are DMing me asking me if this is true. They'll, like, make up shit that's so obvious to everyone else. But to them, they're like, yeah, they'll buy this.
Has it ever happened with you guys, Garrett?
I wouldn't say that kids are DMing me for any reason whatsoever.
I was going to say, too, that, but that's also kind of like, yeah, maybe don't mention, you know, why are you fucking DMing kids?
Yeah,
like,
why?
Have you ever had, like, somebody you were spoofing or whatever get pissed at you guys and ask you to, like, remove something?
I don't know. I'm, not me. I wonder if it's happened to the boys. I'm pretty far removed, you know, being like the props and costumes guy. You know, like they don't email me.
Right,
sometimes
right.
When people can't get through to anyone else, they'll fucking at me. But no, I never really get anything like that. Like, is this about me? Take this down.
It might be. Is Sean Chatfield gang stalking me?
Yeah. The last man
oh.
that would ever. Yeah.
He might be. Yeah, he's been leaving really early, and
he's been saying he needs to like take care of some stuff.
Yeah. He's just not around the studios much lately. He's like always
got
an excuse.
The best personal video you've ever uploaded, I would say top five was when that lady like accosted you in that parking lot.
Oh, and the
said
McCraskle.
Like, yeah, the McCraskle. It's like, are you my nephew? I wouldn't have said yeah, but you were so perfect in saying
her
yeah.
Nephew. I'm
they're looking for you, the cops.
Tennessee.
The cops are looking for you
oh,
at the McDonald's. They were?
Demo. Yeah, I had gone into that McDonald's at like 5 a.m. and got breakfast. And then the lady told me like, yeah, this homeless woman just destroyed our bathroom, sprayed water everywhere, ripped the fixtures off the wall. We had to call the cops.
Whoa, what a
and
party,
she
huh?
just ran out of
Those
here.
Guys really
like.
Live it up.
It was crazy. And then I was driving across the parking lot after she told me that, and I ran into the McRascal herself. And I knew it could only have been her because she was taking her clothes off in the middle of the street and kind of like peeling a sweater off and then like leaving it in the street and then like kicking a boot off and leaving it in the crosswalk. And then like a sock came off in the sidewalk. You know, and then finally, like, in the parking lot, she was, you know, down to just t-shirt and jeans, like you saw her.
That was...
It was
That's a lot more... That's a lot more lore than the video lets on, honestly.
Yeah. Oh, there was a whole preamble, you know, because I had to get ready. I was like, bro, I got to get the food ready, because McDonald's is only good for, like, what would you say, about a minute 30 before you get it from the drive-thru, Kevin? Before
it depends on what you get.
Yeah, pretty quick shelf life on that.
Yeah, so you got to get the food out and you got to start eating, but then also I got to get my flip video out because these are those days. I watched that video now, though, and I feel so bad for the McRascal, and I hope she's doing all right.
You hope
some people have said that they've seen her. They've seen her around town, still,
still
hanging and banging.
You should feel bad because it's very clear that she's down and out and whatnot. But your execution there was like, yeah, I'm your nephew, and you warned her about the cops. Like, it's like, yeah, they're looking for you.
That's the thing is like, I feel bad because I drive away when she gets close, but also like. I warned her. I was trying to be a nice guy, let her know the cops are coming. But then, you know, also, I've got to be weary. The cops are coming because she trashed the bathroom. Maybe she's going to trash my car, so don't let her get too close. So when she, like,
tries to
up on the window,
how do you know
away.
What her relationship with the nephew is?
Yeah, I
how
know
do you
if
know
Colin was a good guy or a bad guy.
Yeah, what if Colin
Maybe
was evil?
A little bit later, Colin owes her some money.
Yeah, you don't know this.
She's a dude, man. You know, she's
the McRascal.
She's doing all right, hopefully.
It's so good. Oh, another thing I want to get like the inside thing on is the JFK. What was his name again? John F. Kennedy. What was the reference?
You throw that out there, and in my mind, it's like that's familiar to me. But did I say that in a Gamer Wars video?
No, it was a Rocco Things Garrett Has Said Volume 3.
oh well, yeah, you know those are mostly from the days of exhaustion around the studio. This is like. Back to our second studio in the two car roll up garage. We're talking like 2005, 13. I was working like 8 to 10 hour days and then coming into the studio and then hanging out or shipping merch or just working on stuff for another 4 hours. It'd be like, you know, nighttime and I'm exhausted. And then my brain doesn't work all that great. So Rocco would like take quotes out of context, you know.
4th of July stupid. Weekend. What weekend is that again?
Oh yeah, 4th of July. Well, I also will kind of speak before thinking a lot of the time, which I think is why you get great
why a guy's standing Garrett. In the dark.
You get great Garrettisms like Baja Moss and
K-Town.
Digital Forever. K-Town. You know, as you've seen, this is a one of a kind.
Well, that's getting not a Garrett here. Stream without it. That makes us feel perfect.
Yeah. I must say so much wrong shit every PPS when I'm trying to play a game and stream at the same time.
Oh, it's hard to walk. Like. Oh, yeah. It's hard to walk and chew gum at the same time. I'm the idiot of the stream. It's. I feel it.
It's great with guests, though.
Oh, yeah, because you guys could do the job for me and be funny, and so I don't have to.
What are you guys playing tomorrow, Garrett?
Tomorrow, I haven't thought about it yet. A lot of the times it's like this. I'll just...
Oh, you know what you gotta play?
Kind of wait until the last minute.
You gotta play the M. Dickey prison game.
Is this on...
PC.
PC, yeah, I would figure. What is that?
It is the most bizarre. It's called Hard Time. It's all made by one guy.
Think we might save this for like our 420 stream where we play like weird itch.io games.
Do that. It is so crazy. You'll just walk around the prison and like a guard will be like, "I don't like you. We don't like white people around here." Or like If your intelligence is low enough, it's like, "You're the dumbest guy I've ever seen. I'm gonna beat the crap out of you to death." And like, it's janky. It's like, you have to play it to know it, and you will have a blast. You'll have a blast playing it.
One guy's entire baby. He did it all himself.
Yeah, that's what's cool about him.
You must be stoked. The team usually doesn't bring hams on a trip this.
Well, it must be good. I mean,
what's actually crazy is that he got so good at solo game development, he actually made his most recent release is actually the best wrestling game made in decades, which is Wrestling Empire.
Okay.
It is legitimately a good game. It's like the N64 games, the wrestling games. He basically channeled all that energy into making like one of the greatest like wrestling games to be made recently.
The same developer.
Same developer. All done by himself. Matt Dickey.
What was the name of it? Matt Dickey. Got a lot of notes for today.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I love turning people on to stuff. I've streamed Hard Time. He made a New Testament game where you're a disciple of Jesus and you can fly around and shoot lasers out of your hands and kill people.
Well, I was thinking, like, the guy who did Undertale, you know, like...
Oh, Toby Fox?
That game. Yeah, yeah. That's all one-person operation. It has to be...
This is a bit different. Like, he had, like, an era where he wasn't that good at making games. And then he has this new era where he's, like, legit... He had to... Like, when he started making mobile games is when he started hitting his, like... Like, because I actually played every game he's ever made. And, like, once you start making mobile games and 2D...
You're a Matt Dickey fanatic, it seems.
I actually am! Because he makes really fun games to, like, fuck around with.
Wait, so are they, like, fun games, or they're kind of, like, just, like, so bad they're fun?
Earlier, so bad they're fun. Newer, legitimately good.
I was going to say, because it sounds like this guy almost seems like the Neil Breen of video games, the way you're describing.
Evolution. He learned how to, like, make games by himself. He has an ego, so he'll be like, "No, my old games were good." But it's like, no, oh, dude. Like, cool. Once you got, like, figured it out, you were great. All right, do a kickflip.
He's like Hideki Kamiya of the indies.
Yeah, maybe. He actually gets heated whenever, like, small children are like, "You should make your games for free." And he, like, posts, like, a rant about people asking to make his games for free. I'm like, I just want to be like, dude, you're aware of these kids. These are obviously children. Oh, so I just got to,
So you're at the beach now?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm in Hawaii. Marge is at the beach. Wow.
Mrs. Serb Simpson?
Serb Simpson. Where's the next guys?
One of four wedding photos. Yeah, like, this game is not even about skateboarding anymore. It's just, like, do all this, like, reality TV bullshit.
It becomes that skateboard. Even worse. I have to figure out where the wedding photos
when
are.
When it's the BAM show.
Where's the next photo? It doesn't tell you. It should give me an arrow, because this is, like, it's ambiguous.
You got on a plane, so... Did you go to Hawaii, I'm assuming?
Yes. And we're about to do one of, like, the most iconic tricks in the entire series.
Is it the Hawaii 5-0?
Maybe. Yo, Garrett, how much longer you feel comfortable sticking around here on? I don't want to waste your time or nothing.
You know, I got some work to catch back up on. We're filming some stuff for our big week of streaming. And I got some stuff to do a little later, so I don't want to stay here too late. So what have we been going for? Oh, we've been going for like 2.5 hours, huh?
Yeah.
Damn. I could do, like, you know, maybe we start wrapping it up.
Yeah, I was gonna say I probably should start heading off here myself too.
Okay. I got a little bit of work left over.
We'll finish off with the McTwist. We're gonna finish off Hawaii and end it with the McTwist.
Yeah, let's see the McTwist. Yeah.
Let's
finish off this arc and
on a high note.
Yes. Because I feel like you enjoyed your time here. I feel like we'll be definitely
having
you back.
Time. It's fun another person... to just watch gameplay and not have to fucking.
Funny.
I'm just enjoying this.
It's fun to have. It'll be great to have someone new in the ecosystem, man. It'll be great. It's awesome.
Well, I thank you again for having me on, and thank you to the Thought Cops for putting
existing.
Me in touch. For existing. But thank you for coming on, Kev. This was a good time.
Oh, absolutely, man. Serb, thank you for inviting me, because I had a lot of fun, too.
Oh, of course. I love creating and bringing people together. It's
yeah, I mean, like,
sick.
Honestly, man, like, I know, Grant would love to come on. We could do a duo thing again, too. That'd be fun.
Oh, that'd be great. I need guests, man. I need guests.
Yeah. Yeah, get Grant. I need to get in a room with that guy. You know,
yeah, man,
been...
dude, I
and
feel
do
so
what?
Bad about that one fucking time.
He's been dodging me. No, I completely
and that was my fault entirely too.
No. I don't think what Kevin is referring to was, like, you know, I saw Grant for the first time. I finally got to meet Grant when Kevin and Grant came out to the Mega 64 Last Laugh show in Chicago. But then afterwards I met up with you know, Kevin, Nico, a bunch of people from
Zwick,
the Thought Cops Discord,
Josh,
Zwick,
yeah.
Josh, was that IO Netrunner there?
No, he wasn't there.
Damn it, the one name I pulled out, swing and a miss. But anyway, it was a whole thing, like, where we were going out for like a couple hangouts at some arcade bars afterwards. But I get it, you know, you got to work the next morning. Grant couldn't come out, but I just feel like I've had all these opportunities. I always miss Grant, so I gotta pin him down.
Yeah, well, like, what happened was, like, so the location was this place called Emporium in Chicago. It's, like you said, a bar arcade. And
oh, that's right. I forgot all about this.
Yeah, and I forgot that there was more than one of them, because, like, there
was
one, like,
you,
really...
What? You get trying to
go
meet
to
somebody,
the, there's,
go to Emporium?
At a bar, yeah, and there's two Emporiums?
Three, actually. That was
never happened.
Because I think I just told you Emporium, and, like...
Oh, there's poop in the pool.
I didn't think to say which one, so then you guys ended up at a different one, and we were at the other one, and, like, we had Grant with us at that location, and he's like, yeah, I can hang out for, like, an hour or so, and that was kind of close to where he lives. But then the other one, you guys were closer to where I live, and it's obviously, like, a big city, so...
It was a miscommunication, and I totally even forgot about that. That added up to it.
And so then, yeah,
but
he he's like, yeah, I can't really get out. You know, I rode my bike. I can't be, you know, biking all the way out there and biking home with work tomorrow. Yeah. So,
no, hell no. I know
he's wearing bikini
shorts, and it was almost winter.
Nice, yeah, And that's not the first time. You know, you think I would have learned better too, because like that's not the first time that's happened to me with the fucking Emporium. Like, that's like happened twice before. Like, not my fault before, but like other places where it's like, hey, where are you at? And I'm like, I'm at Emporium. Which one?
I see.
Yeah.
I see a pattern. Kevin, you're gatekeeping Grant from me. I see.
I'm like, hey, Grant, I'm going to meet you over there. Just
by that bush.
Show up. Yeah. Oh, hey, my bad. Wrong address. Sorry, Grant.
He missed out. I know. I felt bad. The whole crew was there. We were just missing. He was in our hearts.
And I'm glad you guys got to finally meet at the live show.
Yeah, same here. I just wish there was more time to like actually have a conversation. So
yeah.
You know, like we get to do.
When you get come to the Big Apple?
Well, we tried that so far twice, and that's been like the most cramped and hassle.
That's like the worst
all the
menu.
Getting into, we did Brooklyn this last time, and then the first time we did Manhattan. But both of them were just like my first adventures in New York City, and it was fucking wild.
Well, Johnny was there. Where'd you go? Like, what'd you see?
He was showing us around because he went to school there. What did we see? We saw. I mean, I didn't really give too much of a shit about like.
Oh yeah, Times Square
seeing,
and all that crap.
Seeing Times Square and all that shit, but we went down there just because it was almost everyone's first time in Manhattan, so we looked at that shit. But I mean, I saw this fucking venue that was pretty cool. We didn't see much because it was like in and out and on to the next city so fast. Both of these little excursions into New York were like that. But you know, I saw a little bit of Brooklyn, which was nice this last year. And then what I saw in Manhattan was like, all right, get me the fuck out of here.
Yeah, I've only been in
but
New
it was
York
fun.
Once myself too, and it was yeah.
New York is like I live in New York, so it's it's not that impressive, honestly.
Those videos we saw, you know, when I first got in there, it was like seeing it in media portrayed all my life.
Oh, Paris syndrome.
There's a term for that?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's cool.
When a city is like less like more shitty than like you thought it was gonna be, yeah, Paris syndrome.
It was. It looked like I was on a soundstage. It was like I stepped onto the set of New York when I got out of the van for the first time in Manhattan. I was like, "Yo, it's like whoa, this is smaller than I thought."
But dude, the first time I went to Tokyo though, like I was like, "This is everything and more."
Yeah, that was a little overload. But, you know what? I really liked it. I think the inner city destinations were my favorite. Like, Chicago.
Chicago
Detroit,
is a very clean city.
You been here, sir?
New York.
Yeah, I've been there for ASIN.
Oh, that's right. I forgot we talked about it. Dude, that's so crazy. We were probably at the same conventions.
Yeah, I know. I was like, I wouldn't say I'm a somebody, but I was just like a regular jack off back then, just there with my like internet friends, man. It was awesome.
Yeah.
It was so cool. I was there to buy shit. I bought so many anime figures.
Cons were fun.
I bought so many anime figures, man. Like I spent $200 on one anime figure. It was a Kill Me Baby figure, and it was purely because you couldn't find it online anywhere. It was a rare figure. I have it on my desk. And it's beautiful. I love that crap.
And I gotta go to a con again because it's been like a few years, and like after this whole crazy couple of years we've had, I'm just like, I want to go to a con with my friends, get a hotel room, and just like fuck around for a weekend, you know?
Oh, so into that. Like, I miss the cringe level of a live convention setting.
Oh God,
so
yeah.
I never thought I would say this because I was frankly burnt out having
for
to
you
work
guys. It's
so
a little
many.
Different.
Yeah, so it's weird saying this now, but wow, I really miss it.
It's just a very natural, just enjoy, chilling, enjoying yourself type thing. Like, yeah, of course everyone there
maybe
is cringe, but like it's...
Maybe it's a thing of the past. Maybe they're gone.
We'll see. I mean, like...
MAGFest just happened.
That's
MAGFest
yeah,
happened very much so. And no one
people who are on Twitter are saying like, yeah, I'm not going.
But
well, they're probably a lot safer. I heard that a lot of people got sick.
I went to a I went to an AEW show during December. I ended up fine. But like,
I mean, you gotta live, you know. Like, if you're doing, like, you're getting.
Oh yeah.
It's either this is gonna go on forever or it isn't. Like, I understand. Like, you can't like constantly be a hermit. Like, there's gotta be a point where it's like, I mean, I got my jabs. That's what I'll say. I got my jabs.
I still got fucking sick, but then after, like, honestly, I'm better now, and I think I'm at a point where it's like, they say what the antibodies are, you know, pretty strong for a few months. So I'm like, yeah, I'm like, I'm not worried about fucking anything now.
Hell yeah.
I don't know the exact science on that. I probably made it. Maybe that'll bite me in the ass. But like, I mean, fuck. I'm just, you know.
I like just. Doing enough to not worry about it, like you just said, Kevin.
Yeah.
There's a way to go to a con, and there's a way to do a tour, and there's a way to do all kinds of shit safely, or that you feel safe with. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And I mean, like, obviously, so I would like to get back to normal.
I'm doing that.
Like,
I don't know about a con. I haven't been back to a con. There's been a couple that have happened, but I'm curious how I'll feel when I'm there. The scariest thing for me has been fucking getting on airplanes.
I was on an airplane during the peak of Corona, and that was fucking weird.
It's like nerve wracking on a whole nother level.
Yeah.
During the peak of all of that, it was fucking weird, man. I was like, I'm not neurotic now, but back then I was like the most neurotic person possible. I was like, I had to stay at a hospital bed in Louisiana during, like, when it's just all kicking off. I sprayed the shit out of a bed.
Oh.
Over that shit.
Like, I don't trust it. I saw a couple ladies in the movie theater with Lysol. That was cool.
When you didn't know...
Just clean it up. You know.
Well, we got the big twist now.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Eric, I found it. Get up here and bring the camera.
You are obsessed with this Eric guy. Your rival.
Yeah, he's my rival. Well, he's my friend at this point.
Yeah, you guys are coming up together.
Yeah, we're coming up.
It's crazy how cinematic this game is, too.
That's what makes it so cool.
I've only played the regular ones, yeah.
It worked.
You serious? You miss your Ollie, we'll be sending you back to Jersey in a coffee can. Todd said he wanted something big. This is it.
Isn't that the way they bury them in Jersey?
It is. They call it the Jersey Viking funeral.
The old Folgers coffee can.
The old Folgers funeral.
Jersey Viking.
Oh, I gotta get special and get my way to bed.
Oh. Well, looks like you're going back to Jersey
in
a
coffee
can.
Oh. Coffee can count. I don't know if I have the stats for this.
Two cans,
Sam.
You got this. You just need the speed.
Oh, I got grinds.
Yeah, the speed, but
I gotta get the special first. Oh, my
knee! Get your special up so you can grind that. Oh, that's right. This would piss me off because you'd have to get your special up before you could grind.
There we go.
There you go. Nice.
Hell yeah.
Get 50,000 points on the roof. Here we go.
You made Eric very happy.
Eric is not happy. I failed.
Well.
You made Eric very happy. Speaking of Eric, I think of Eric Bedore. I don't even know how to pronounce his last name. When you were doing the shitty DVDs episode, it was like, yeah, so he's watched this DVD called Wrestle Shoot Kingdom, and off screen he cuts it. He's like, no, you guys don't get what that DVD actually was. You can't say it sucked. You don't know what a wrestling shoot is. And he's like, in the wrestling community, they have this thing called shoots. Shoot interviews. And like Rocco's like, I saw it and it sucked. There was a guy on there that looked like a grapefruit.
Eric is specifically the reason I got into wrestling back like when he lived with me. He just fucking obsessed.
Yeah.
Him and Brian, I should say. They were both, like, always talking about fucking At the time, it was like WWE, because I think they were podcasting about it, too. They did the Go Home show for a couple of years. And it was just, like, always in my fucking house, and then I, like, got sucked in, dude. It's, like, a weird
AEW made it very easy.
Yeah, so then, like,
there we go.
Getting out of it,
oh, man.
Twist over the chopper.
Oh, shit. But I got better.
Getting back into it with AEW has been really easy, and, like, Johnny and Derek have been my main influences now.
I like,
I come in, I'm asking him, I'm like, yo, what's up with this Serena D bitch? She seems like a mean lady.
I love Eddie Kingston, because he's just like, I'm from Yonkers! And you, CM Punk!
Yeah.
CM Punk, you don't know! You don't know CM Punk!
Oh, shit.
How over the top the characters of, like, just a Brooklyn dude, like Eddie Kingston.
He's like, CM Punk, I was there when the towers fell. You weren't. Where were you? You were in Chicago. CM Punk, I don't respect you. I was there. I knew first responders.
This guy wrestles in fucking Timberlands and, like, sweatpants. He's just like, yeah, I'm from fucking New York. I wear sweatpants. I got the butters on and a fucking hoodie.
There we go. We did
Everyone
it.
Else is in fucking underwear. It's great. It's a great gimmick.
So you did it, sir.
I did it.
McTwist.
Congratulations.
Oh, yeah, I got it.
McTwisted.
I can't believe I did that. That's the
Looks like Eric got it on tape, too.
Exactly.
Anybody ever filmed.
Stay where you are.
Well, is there anything we should send off with, gentlemen?
Well, Garrett, you have anything to sheepishly allude to for the fans in the upcoming stuff?
Ooh.
Be very cryptic.
Cryptic things. Well, we are streaming on our Twitch.
We should plug it.
That's the Mega 64 official.
You don't even need to plug it. That's implied.
Here's the 411 on Vancouver. Yeah, I don't know. There's a. It's actually. I didn't even get
by,
it right,
by,
so I probably
by plug,
should.
By plug. By plug, I don't mean plug in chat. People know these.
I should plug it correctly, though. The
yes.
Mega 64 podcast on Twitch.
Oh, dude,
we're streaming all week long. We started on Monday, and we've got a lot of
new developments
in store. Yeah, a lot of stuff live 24/7 for the whole week with many... many things to come. In fact, I'm going to go work on some of them now. I've been pre-recording some stuff and setting up a bunch of new sets, and I think we've got some cool treats in store. But thanks for having me on, fellas.
I'm so glad to meet you. I'm glad that we hit it off as well as we did. I would love to have you back on. I'll definitely keep you on my Rolodex.
Yeah, we'll be in touch. DM me and... Kevin, always a fun time hanging out with you as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. And so, I do want to say as well, if I could get a plug in myself, sir.
Of course.
Do it.
Yeah. What am I going to do, say
listen,
no?
Yeah, no. listen to Thought Cops. We just hit our 5-year mark doing the show. We've been doing it almost every week for 5 years.
Great production quality, great guest repertoire.
Thank you. Yeah, we've like I said, we got a lot of crossover with Kimono Friend Zone. So I would say just scroll through the episodes, see if there's someone you know, or if you want to start with the most recent one. Talk about the most relevant topics, and we got some fun stuff coming up soon. So stay tuned. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Kevin Potus, and you can get all the updates on everything, the latest and greatest there.
So Garrett, since we're gonna probably end this right now, is there any creators that are online right now that you see on the
sure.
Mega 64 stuff that we could send this raid to?
I know I would be gauche to say raid our channel right now, but let's see.
Looks like Johnny's doing something.
Yeah, Johnny is doing something on
let's get,
our
let's
channel.
Get,
so,
yeah, Mega 64. He's doing
coach.
Something right there. All right, Mega 64
he's
podcast.
He's on the Mega 64 podcast. Send him on over to Johnny. He's doing a little Johnny TV for our week long of interactive streaming. I've got some stuff I've been preparing, and there's a lot to come. But yeah, thanks for the. Thanks for the raid,
homie. It's always a pleasure. All right, everybody. I love all of y'all the bits. Thanks for coming by. Thanks for seeing all the sorts of new faces. I love y'all the bits.
Garrett, thank you for coming on. Kevin, thanks for being a pal like always. And I will see you guys next Tuesday.
Peace.